Live from Binghamton, New York, Carolina Thunderbirds hockey is on the air from the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. It's game two of this weekend series between the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Binghamton Black Bears. Live here from upstate New York, last night a 5-4 shootout victory for the Thunderbirds in a dramatic, nail-biting, and thrilling game that went all the way down to the final seconds in regulation. Carolina never trailed, but they did end up losing a lead late, giving up two goals on 6-on-4 that allowed for Binghamton to send it to overtime. But in the overtime frame, neither side could push across a goal. And then in the shootout, it was Gus Ford in the second round being able to put the Thunderbirds ahead. And then Mario Cavalieri, he stopped all three shots he saw as the Thunderbirds got out of game one here in upstate New York with a 5-4 shutout victory to pick up their third straight win and improve to 4-1-0 on the season. With that, we welcome you inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV, getting you set for what should be another thrilling game here between two of the top teams in the FPHL. The Thunderbirds coming in today at 4-1-0 on the season after the win last night on the other side. Binghamton at 5-0-3. They have still yet to lose a game in regulation, with the Black Bears sitting at 18 points atop the Empire Division in the FPHL, while in the Continental Division, Carolina with 11 points, trailing Columbus, who has 15, and Mississippi, who has 12 after they got a regulation win last night. But last night, though, in that game number one, it was a high-scoring affair, and it was high-flying action throughout. As the Thunderbirds got the scoring started in that first period, is a pair of goals, one coming from Dawson Baker that put them up 1-0, and then Roman Kramer being able to get his third goal on the season, both on the power play in the first period. But then Binghamton wouldn't go away. They're able to tie it up in the second. And before the end of that second period, the Thunderbirds were able to kill off a penalty kill. And then coming out of box was Gus Ford. Jacob Schnapp took it all the way from his defensive zone, was able to bring all the way up the ice, get it to Ford, who threw it on net. The puck was batted around, and it came back onto the stick of Jacob Schnapp, who was able to slot one to make it 3-2 going into the final period. And then at the 15:38 mark of that third period, Schnapp was able to make it a 4-2 game with a beautiful move that he walked into the dot and was able to snap one home. It made it 4-2, but Binghamton, after penalties against Gregory Felder and then as well Jacob Schnapp, and over the final 3 minutes with the goalie pulled in 6-on-4, they were able to tie the game up with 5 seconds left on a Connor Smith goal that made it 4-4 in the overtime. Neither side were able to score, and then as I said, Gus Ford, he was able to slot one home on in the shootout, and Mario Cavalieri stood tall as the Thunderbirds took game one of this set here this weekend, are now looking to try to sweep the Binghamton Black Bears and hand them consecutive losses for the first time this year. It should be a fun one here on Veterans Day at the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. For myself and everyone on the team and everyone on the staff as well, we want to thank our veterans and our active duty military still there that allows for us to be able to bring you this presentation here tonight in this game of Carolina Thunderbirds hockey. Great night on tap and a great conversation with the head coach, Steve Harrison. I caught up with him earlier today. We'll hear from the head coach coming up on the other side of this break on Thunderbirds pregame.
Hey, Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
Or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com, and mention the Thunderbirds, and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. ComTech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Flow Garage app helps you keep up with your vehicles from anywhere. Flow customers can request service appointments, receive text and video updates, view sales and service history, receive recall notifications, and even get purchase offers via Flow Offer to Purchase. Download the app today.
What's up, everybody? My name is Zach Taylor, and I'm the owner of Little Donuts. We're a mini donut food truck company specializing in apple cider mini donuts, traveling all over, setting up at different events. This year, I'm happy to announce that we are a proud partner of the Carolina Thunderbirds, and we're going to be set up inside the Annex building all season long at every home game. So while you're out supporting your favorite hockey team, swing by and warm up with some hot, fresh apple cider mini donuts made on site right when you order. Thank you. Hope you have a great day, and go Birds.
Back here on Thunderbirds pregame, Brendan Riley with you, being joined by the head coach of the Thunderbirds, Steve Harrison, as we're getting you ready for game two between Binghamton and Carolina. Well, coach, last night, an exciting game. Went to overtime, went to the shootout, and you guys were able to pull out a win. Tough place to play and a very good team, and but your team was still able to come away with 2 points.
Yeah, it was a great atmosphere last night. I mean, a nice building, and they had a good crowd here, and two good hockey teams. So, you know, even the coach after, you know, it was a great game. If you come to a hockey game, that was a great game to watch last night. And you know what? I liked it. Our resiliency last night was unbelievable. We came out hard, and you know, we kept fighting. And at the end of the night, we got a couple points out of it. So, no, I'm really happy with the way things went last night. As I said, we know we can be better in certain situations, but overall, it was a great hockey game and a great atmosphere. And as I said, we grabbed some points.
Now you come out and get a quick 2-0 lead, or you take a 2-0 lead into the first intermission. Both goals coming on the power play, but team played really well over those first 20 minutes.
Yeah, we did. We knew they were coming out, and they came out, but we weathered the storm and we played very well. We didn't give them a whole lot. They had a few shots. We collapsed. As I said, the pressure last night was probably more than we've seen so far. So again, we weathered that storm, and I thought we played a great first period. And as I said, I couldn't have been happier after that.
Now, the second period, they came out, and they came out quick, and they really controlled that second period. But you give up the two goals to tie it up, but then Jacob Schnapp at the end of the period, with Gus coming out of the penalty box, makes a great play and is able to set up a chance there to take the lead into the third.
Well, I hate to say I was right. I told the players they were going to come out storming in that second period, and we weren't ready. And it was a learning lesson for us last night. We've got to be better in those situations. And again, what I like the most is we bent, we didn't break. And again, you know, we capitalized on a turnover right late in the period there and take a 3-2 lead. So we bent a little bit, but I always tell the guys it's how we respond to adversity, and we responded great. And as I said, we don't like to have that adversity like we did at the second period. But again, it's how we responded, and we had a good job.
Now in the third period, you know, both teams seemed like they were kind of figuring each other out over the first half. Then Schnapp's able to get his second goal of the game, double the lead, but then a couple penalties late and a couple 6-on-4 chances ended up tying it up.
Well, yeah, he made a great individual effort there, Schnappi, and as I said, handled the puck, made a nice move on the defense, and then scored a nice goal and gave us that lead. And unfortunately, a couple of maybe questionable calls, especially the last one there to go 6-on-4, and they scored 2 6-on-4 goals. So overall, great effort. Again, bent a little bit, but we found a way to win in overtime or in the shootout, and my hat's off to the guys who last night, they kept plugging away all night long.
Now, we talked about it on the coaches show earlier this week, even before we talked prior to game one, but after seeing Binghamton, one of the top teams in the league, where do you think that your team currently stacks up here? Still only 5 games into the season.
Well, I liked it. I know where we're at. I know how they're at, and I think they were coming on all cylinders last night. I think we can be better in all facets of the game. So I'm excited about this team. Would I like to be playing better? No question. But as I said, it's a long season, and we're getting this thing going, and they're starting to figure me out, and I'm starting to figure them out and how we're going to go. So right now I'm tickled pink of how we're going, and we'll see tonight if we can respond back after a win like last night and show them what we have. But right now I feel good about our team, and because I know how good we're going to be down the road a little bit here. So I'm excited.
Now, game two tonight, you can try to come away with a sweep. What do you guys have to do?
Well, we have to. Again, they're going to come out tonight because they're going to have a big crowd again, apparently, and they're going to want to take revenge. And when teams are hungry like that, we have to match their intensity and make sure that we're ready and play smart hockey and don't get run around. And as I said, take chances and capitalize on their mistakes.
Well, Coach, thank you very much for your time. Congrats on last night, and good luck to you here tonight. That's the head coach, Steve Harrison. We're back with more from Binghamton after this on Thunderbirds TV.
Hey, Michael and Jennifer Anderson with A4 Services. We are proud supporters of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Can't wait to see you all at the Annex. Go Birds!
Mabel Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pinebrook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green, and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done. Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker. One with big heart, they were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start.
From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score.
So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
Proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Parish Tire and Automotive, your reliable, local, and honest choice. In Winston-Salem, Mount Airy, Dobson, Jonesville, and Clemens. Go Birds!
Back here in Binghamton as the Black Bears are getting ready to take the ice here for game two of this weekend set between the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Binghamton Black Bears here on Veterans Day. Here live from upstate New York at the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. The Thunderbirds last night, a 5-4 victory in the shootout over the Binghamton Black Bears as Carolina comes into this evening at 4-1-0 with 11 points on the campaign, currently sitting in third in the Continental Division. Binghamton on the other side, 18 points to start off this year. They have not played in a game that they have not been able to get a point this season. They have not lost two in a row either. 5-0-3 record with 18 points this season. So now the Thunderbirds, a tough test, and now they're going to have to try to do it shorthanded as well again tonight. Of course, if you were with us last night, Yuri Peshtuka did not make the trip up to Binghamton, and also joining him as out tonight is Curtis Heggie after he took a hit in the second period last night. He is awaiting further evaluation as the team gets back to Winston-Salem. So both Yuri Peshtuka and Curtis Heggie out tonight. So the Thunderbirds only playing with five defensemen here this evening as Carolina has just taken the ice. And they will start with Joe Kennedy and Clay Keeley. The two defensemen have started now each of the last three and four games now. With Kennedy and Keeley at the defensemen, it'll be Gregory Felder and Tucker Firth in the second line of D-men with Jordan Popoff, the fifth defenseman. Roman Kramer, Gus Ford, and Dawson Baker. Every guy had at least a point last night. Kramer a goal, Gus Ford 3 points, and Dawson Baker a goal and assist. They will be the starters tonight. And you have the check line with Dominic Dumas in the second line, with John Batita the captain, Nate Keeley, and Jacob Schnapp the third line, with Kessler Sky as the 10th skater this evening. And in net for the Thunderbirds tonight, it is Mario Cavalieri, saved 36 of 40 last night and 3-for-3 in the shootout. We will get to the netminder and the starters this evening for Binghamton after we take a live listen in here at the National Anthem here on Veterans Day.
Tonight's honorary starters of the game, please welcome United States Navy E-5 veteran, Petty Officer 2nd Class, and United States Army E-5 veteran, Sergeant Ron Bell. Also, from the United States Army, please welcome retired Staff Sergeant Michael Avery. My sister and me, to the world. From the United States Marine Corps, please welcome Sergeant Kara Tilton. Up next from the Navy, please welcome back Black Bears season ticket holders and married couple, Master Chief Mess Management Specialist Kevin Justicine and his wife, Chief Hospital Corpsman, Fleet Marine Force, Veteran Melissa Justicine. We welcome United States Air Force Reserve and Air National Guard member who served combat deployment in Iraq and Syria, now serving the 174th Attack Wing in Syracuse, New York, ladies and gentlemen, Master Sergeant Joshua M. Reed.
Great scene here in Binghamton, New York, here on Veterans Day. The Black Bears honoring servicemen and women. God Bless America, and a great rendition of the national anthem with the Black Bears also holding out the American flag at center ice. A great scene here on Veterans Day. And once again, from everyone, myself and with the Thunderbirds, we thank our servicemen and women for everything that they've done for us to be able to enjoy this game here tonight and for everything they've done to keep our country safe. So we are just about set for puck drop. The starters for the Binghamton Black Bears, they go with the first line of Mac Lewis, Tyson Kirkby, and Gavin Yates. Going left to right on the forwards, the defensemen are Dakota Bond and Daniel Stone. And the netminder tonight is Nolan Egbert. 2-0-1 this season with a .332 goals against average and an .886 save percentage. His last start came against Watertown back on October 28th, where he saved 28 out of 31 shots in a 5-3 victory for the Black Bears, who are wearing special camo jerseys here on Veterans Day. The Thunderbirds wearing their road white jerseys with the black helmets, black pants, white socks with the red, black, or the red and black trim. 5-4 shootout victory last night for the Carolina Thunderbirds as they were able to take game one of this series, and now they're trying to sweep them here this weekend and pick up their fourth consecutive win on the season. As now John Batita and Tyson Kirkby partake in the honorary puck drop, the two captains for both sides. Down to the right of us here. Carolina trying to come away with another victory here this evening. 4-1-0 season started in Danbury. A couple weeks back at the turn of the month, they were able to split up in Danbury, winning on their opening night, dropping game two by a score of 2-1. Game two coming up, or rather, last weekend split the home-and-home set, and now, or rather, took the home-and-home set, taking all 6 points from Blue Ridge, who the Thunderbirds will see next weekend. And now they're trying to take 5 points here this weekend with one. Only got two last night for the overtime victory. And so now they're trying to take all 3 points here this evening, take five on the weekend. Try to put themselves in a good position here after the first 3 weeks of the season. Columbus idle tonight after they took the game three last night against Baton Rouge. Mississippi back in action against Blue Ridge. Those are the two teams ahead of the Thunderbirds right now in the Continental Division. As we are set for puck drop here from the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. This first period, as always throughout the season, is brought to you by First Bank. Gus Ford and Tyson Kirkby in for the draw, and we're underway here on a Saturday night in upstate New York. It'll be Binghamton controlling first as Kirkby dumps it in into the far corner, and Joe Kennedy, he gets ran into by two Black Bears. Puck still tangled up in the corner. Just underway here from Binghamton as the puck bounces free, and Gus Ford comes away with it, and now here comes the Thunderbirds. On the far side, Roman Kramer, he gets ran into. Puck still continues to move deep, but coming away with it and turning up ice now is Gavin Yates as he gets only to the blue line, though, as Ford picks his pocket, tries to float into Kramer back out in the center of the zone, but it bounces all the way back out. Now here's Yates across the blue line, walks in top of the dot, just throws one in on Mario Cavalieri, who makes his first save of the evening 40 seconds into this one. Cavalieri last night, 36 for 40. And then went 3 for 3 in the shootout. Last night, the Thunderbirds outshot quite a bit. They'll bring out both second lines as Peter Panacek goes in against Brendan Stenko just to the right of Cavalieri. Panacek, he gets tied up. Stenko is just able to get this one off, and it'll be covered by Cavalieri. It's only 5 seconds ran off the clock there. It'll be another face-off. Thunderbirds struggled at the dot yesterday. It's one, but it's knocked all the way back out to the blue line. Weber tries to keep it in, and he does. He rattles it around the boards, and closing down, and it's Jan Salak. He pokes it over to Gregory Felder as this gets whacked by Tucker Firth over to the far half boards, and it's lifted out of the zone, back out to center ice, and back to control. His boy Sard, but here comes Panacek, walks in, throws one across in front, and a save. Firth there for the rebound, and he scores! The Thunderbirds, only on their second rush here tonight, are able to get Egbert out of his crease. Tucker Firth is there at the top of the slot, and he's able to put one home. And just 69 seconds into this one, the Thunderbirds have taken a 1-0 lead. A fast start for Carolina as they pick up a riddle track their goal and take a 1-0 advantage here early in game two. In for the reset now, a tie-up and a scrum there between Peter Panacek and Dustin Jussieu. Looks like both will be tossed out as now Jan Salak comes in against Austin Thompson. And Salak's able to win the draw, but only for a second is now on the near side. There goes the hand up as Panacek, he's going to go to the box. After a tie-up, Jussieu came right back, and now a cheap hit, and now we got a brawl down on the near side. Oh, a cheap shot. After the whistle, play was already dead. And after a pretty clean game last night, we already got physicality here earlier. Clay Keeley stepping in. While Lars still wants it, he drops his gloves. He's going to make his way to the box. As Panacek as well, he's going to head to the box. So we're going to have some early extracurriculars to sort out. So the Thunderbirds already up 1-0. Matthew Boyes-Lord, as well as Peter Panacek, he makes his way to the penalty box. And so it looks like it's going to be a pair of minors for both. 2 minutes shows up on the scoreboard. And we are going to have, for what it looks like, 4-on-4 action. So now the officials will bring the puck back out to the neutral zone. It'll be a neutral zone faceoff with Gus Ford stepping in. Tie up on the faceoff, and it's won by Binghamton and played back by Dustin Jussieu. Goes up the far side and comes back out to Gus Ford, who plays it back behind his own goal line to Gregory Felder. Pass gets deflected, but Ford comes away with it, goes cross ice. A nice snap pass to Baker. Baker across the blue line first, able to stay onside. He tries to leave one for the top of the slot, but all he found was Dustin Jussieu. Walks up, 2-on-2. Jussieu walks in, and a save by Cavalieri. A good save there from Cavalieri. Some open ice, saw 3-on-3 in the overtime last night, and now 4-on-4. Pair of penalties, 1:34 left to go on the 2-minute infractions for both. As in for the faceoff was Nate Keeley. He's able to win it back to Joe Kennedy. Plays it back on the near side to Jordan Popoff. Only 5 defensemen for the Thunderbirds this evening, with Curtis Hege out tonight. They'll undergo further evaluations when the team gets back to Winston-Salem this week. Here's Jacob Schnapp, pair of goals for him last night. Cross the blue line, and they're offside.
If your Black Bears score 4 goals in tonight's game.
So it's 17:57 left to go in the first period. Thunderbirds already a 1-0 lead here on Veterans Day. 1:15 left to go on the pair of minors. Stanko versus Keeley on the faceoff, and it's one as Schnott bangs this one back out to the neutral zone. He gets it right back over by the ref's crease and will rattle this one around. Egbert gets out from his goal, doesn't get a stick to it as Popoff steps up on the forecheck, but gets discharged over at the half boards. Stretch pass out to the far side. Into the corner now, a pirouette. Kennedy going to work as the puck still gets tangled up in the corner. Kennedy, a nice job there, is able to shove a man out of the way, but as it's played out to the dot. Puck still loose behind the net. Smith trying to step up, and now Kennedy is able to play this one back out to the point, but only as far as Jesse Anderson. He leaves it there for Connor Smith, who will bring it back out and bring it back into his own defensive zone here with 28 seconds left to go on the pair of 2-minute minors. Thunderbirds go off for a change as now we see our first of Kessler Sky this evening with Jan Salak. Off the far side, Stones able to dish it off as Yates gets it into the zone. He'll backhand this one in. He gets ran into by Popoff as the puck comes out to the near half board. Sky taps it back for Clay Keeley, who goes cross ice to a vacant point as Stones able to get there. And he'll just send this one back in. 5 seconds and 4 left to go here on these 2-minute minors. Puck still now tangled up on the half boards as both players make their way out of the box. 16:39 left to go in the first period. Back to 5-on-5 action with the Thunderbirds in front 1-0 thanks to the goal from Tucker Firth, his first of the season. Back out to the point. Felder will just try to throw it in. It gets knocked down in the slot. Puck still loose out in front of the crease, but Binghamton's able to get to it, and Yates now has it on the near side. He's now able to clear. Felder will throw one in. That one's saved by Egbert. Takes a high deflection over the net as a man loses an edge back behind the net, and it gets rattled all the way back out as Felder keeps it in and sends it right back in. It's left. Stone will play this one. A good check there by Kessler Sky. And now it's cleared out to Kirkby. Throws it off the linesman and now has it at the ref's crease. He'll just play this one in. Here's Ivashkin. He drops it back for Kirkby. Kirkby at the far half boards and into the corner. Almost runs into the official and gets it back out to the point. Here's Weber, a shot, and that one goes wide. Back to collect is Clay Keeley. He gets his stick lifted but has enough on it to get it to Jan Salak as it's knocked back in, but Kessler Sky right there. Sky on the far side getting tangled up with Kirkby, and now it's played at center ice and back into their own defensive zone with Jesse Anderson. Anderson will hold behind his netminder Egbert here with 15:31 left to go in the first period and a 1-0 advantage for the Thunderbirds. Trying to take the sweep here this weekend in Binghamton. Here's Gesso across the blue line into the slot. A shot and a blocker saved by Cavalieri. It's parried off into the near corner. Baker will throw this one all the way back around to empty half boards where Kramer, he tries to clear, doesn't get all of it on it. A shot takes a deflection in front there for the rebound and a shot. That one sails high and wide from Ivashkin, and now here's Kramer. Kramer to center ice to Baker, who walks in into the high slot. His shot gets blocked, deflects into the near half board, spins out of a hit from Ivashkin. Now the two get tangled up there as now Ford comes away with it. Baker just gets thrown to the ground. Delayed penalty coming up for the Thunderbirds. Coming away with it's Kramer over on the far side. Just tries throwing back out in the slot. And the Thunderbirds for the first time here this evening are going to go on the power play as now Ivashkin just takes another hit or puts another hit on Baker. Now Ford's getting in the action. He's tied up with Ivashkin behind the net. Already twice here tonight after the whistle's gone. The two sides getting after, and this time it's Gus Ford in the fray. Trying to protect his line mate Dawson Baker from Nikita Ivashkin, who got tangled up with Baker over on the near side, and then Ivashkin wanted more after the whistle. But as of right now, it will be a Thunderbirds power play. So the Thunderbirds gonna go on the man advantage when we come back after this on Thunderbirds TV.
Hey Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
Or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com, and mention the Thunderbirds, and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
Back in Binghamton, Thunderbirds about to go onto the power play here with 14:49 left to go in this first period, as Ivashkin's gonna head to the bench rather than the sin bin for 2 minutes.
That's some deafening silence right there. It's probably what Carolina's gonna sound like later too. So
this game has been chippy so far. A couple times we've seen extracurriculars already. There's a pair of offsetting, rather it went down to 4-on-4 just a few minutes ago. As always this season, every power play this year is brought to you by Little Italy in Rural Hall. Thunderbirds trying to go and try to get another one on the power play here this weekend. They got a couple last night, both coming in the first period. First one was Dawson Baker. Second one was Roman Kramer. Thunderbirds this season 5-for-18 on the power play, good for 28%. And on the other side, Binghamton 29-for-35, 83% mark on the penalty kill. So the Thunderbirds get a face-off to the left of Egbert, a tie-up on the face-off. This one's cleared back out to Tucker Firth, who had two assists and a goal here tonight. Back over to Ford. Ford walks in, top of the dot. Shot gets blocked by Bond. Comes back to Baker on the far side. Sizes one up for Firth, a one-timer, and that one hit a man in the slot. Looks like it hurt there for Kirkby, but this one's cleared all the way back down. Here are 14:30 left to go and a minute 40 left to go on the power play for the Thunderbirds. Tucker Firth has been a great addition to this power play. Just sets up at the blue line and at the point. He's always left vacant that he's able to get a slap shot in. Usually good things happen when he gets one on net. Kessler Sky deflects this one in. This one's going to go down for icing. Sky just a step in front of the red line. And so now they'll bring up a defensive zone faceoff for the Thunderbirds here in their first power play attempt this evening. Shots on goal so far tonight brought to you by Comtech. Binghamton leading 5-3 in that category is now Ford and Logar. Get tied up. Face off to the right of Mario Cavalier at 14:09 left to go here in the first period from the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Ford and Fletcher in for the draw. Face off is won by Fletcher. Gets it back out to the point. Tries to get it back and cycle down, but Tucker Firth stops it, who leaves it for Roman Kramer. Quick zip pass to Kessler. Sky walks in, loses an edge, and goes down into the corner. And this one will be cleared by Liam Anderson all the way down. As now Sky, he avoids a hit in the near corner. But Cavalieri out from behind his crease with 60 seconds to go here in the power play for the Thunderbirds. Firth up the near side. Gets it to Ford, who tries to get it to the blue line, but it only goes as so far, and it's rattled all the way back in as Firth will play this one quickly to Gus Ford. Ford will walk it up out of his own zone and across center ice. Ford over the blue line to the top of the dot, loses the puck, gets it back. Now we'll cycle with 36 to go here on this power play. Schnapp from behind the net, throws one on net, and Egbert makes a save. Good idea there by Jacob Schnapp as he threw it into the middle of the zone for Dominic Dumas. Dumas didn't get all of that one, and it somehow gets in on Egbert, who's able to make the save with 31 seconds left to go on the power play. A roughing minor against Nikita Ivashkin. Faceoff one, back to the point. Joe Kennedy walks the blue line, goes far side to Panicek, gets it right back to Kennedy. Kennedy back down into the corner. Zips one for Jacob Schnapp, back out to the point. Panicek dances along the blue line, 14 to go. Leaves one for Kennedy, no one-timer. Kennedy gets it, puts one on net, and that one takes a deflection wide on the far side. Schnapp comes away with it. He surveys with 6 seconds and five. Kennedy walks in over to Panicek. Back out to the point. Kennedy, a one-timer. Puck save. Puck still loose in the crease. Egbert sprawling around. Still no one can find it, and it comes back out to Ivashkin. And we have another stoppage, and it looks like it's going to be another penalty. And it's going to go against Binghamton. It looks like it's going to be Tyson Kirkby. So the Thunderbirds, after just coming off the power play, are going to go back onto the power play. So a physical and chippy game here early. As Tyson Kirkby heads to the penalty box after a tie-up in front. Like it might be a cross check after he threw a man down. But a face-off now with Dawson Baker in for the draw. He wins it back to Gus Ford. Ford at the blue line tries to leave it for Baker, but it's taken away. Now here comes Stanko. Stanko in, walks in, saved by Cavalieri. A big save there from Mario Cavalieri, and he will cover. He had a couple of those, especially early on last night. And that time again, Stanko one-on-one, he's able to stone him again. Stanko, 4 goals and 12 assists this season. Arguably the best offensive player and attacking player for Binghamton. He wins the draw, comes back out to the point. Shot sails high and wide, comes out in the near half boards. Thompson, Austin Thompson gets tangled up in the corner. Gus Ford just leaves this one for Tucker Firth with 12:18 left to go here in the first period. Thunderbirds a 1-0 advantage. Here for the first 8 minutes in game number two. Trying to take the sweep here tonight. It's played back in as Daniel Stone will just snap this one back down. And now this one will go all the way down. Chasing after it is Fletcher Cavalieri. He whiffs on the first attempt. Now will shovel this one along the Kessler Sky. Yeah, Josh Fletcher, the 10th skater for Binghamton back there. And it's now Sky. Loses the puck at center ice, but it's played quickly now to Gus Ford as this one comes across. Thunderbirds were offside, and it's played back out to Tucker Firth, who will reset with just about a minute left to go here on the man advantage for the Thunderbirds. Tyson Kirkby, an interference call at the 7:17 mark, putting the Thunderbirds on the power play, which is brought to you by Little Italy. The far side, Firth tries to snap one. It gets deflected and comes back out to center ice. And now Dominic Dumas gets it across the line. The near half boards and into the corner. Dumas rattles one around. Panicek leaves it for Jacob Schnapp. Back out to Panicek and all the way back down. Tic-tac-toe goes on the far side. A one-timer attempt for Keeley. That one goes wide. Puck bounces off the back of the cage and comes back out to the point with 26 to go on the power play. Salak at the near dot throws one back out. Top of the slot, a shot, and that one goes wide on the near side. Took a deflection in front as Clay Keeley was threatening. Salak back out to the high slot. Vanacek, he snaps his stick, and now here comes Binghamton. On the far side, walking in, a shot and a save by Cavalieri. He will cover with 10:48 left to go on the man advantage and in the first period and 5 seconds left to go here in the power play for the Thunderbirds. So brings up a defensive zone faceoff. Kirkby getting ready to come out of the penalty box. Kessler Sky in for the draw, joined by Butita, Nate Keeley, Gregory Felder, and Jordan Popoff. Tie up on the ensuing faceoff to the left of Cavalieri. It's played out to the half boards. Here comes Butita. The penalty is over as Butita, he takes a hit and delivers one to Kirkby coming right out of the box. Popoff now has a neutral zone. He'll walk it in, and the Thunderbirds are offside. So 10:35 remains. Thunderbirds now 0-2 here this evening on the power play. And they got an even strength goal just a minute 9 seconds into this one from Tucker Firth with assists from Dominic Dumas and Peter Panacek. Faceoff in the neutral zone, won by the Thunderbirds. It's tapped in, and back to play it is Dan Weber. Weber going up against Keeley and will backhand this one to his defensive pairing, Matthew Boilar. He holds behind his own net, plays it up the near side to Kirkby. A long stretch pass out to center ice, tries to get it to Connor Smith as now it's played in into the corner, back out to the half boards, comes back out to the point, and Weber's not able to keep it in. So he'll reset now as we approach the midway point here in this first period. Puck goes off the boards and comes back to Nate Keeley, who plays it back for Popoff. Goes to his defensive partner, Gregory Felder. Only 5 defensemen this evening for the Thunderbirds. Kessler Sky is able to walk in, gets the puck taken away, as now it's loose in the slot, and Stone's able to control for Binghamton. Stone now on the near side. Across the red line, brings it into the attacking zone as he goes against Popoff. He spins back out, leaves it for a one-timer from Jusseau, and that one sails wide and comes all the way back out to center ice. Thunderbirds will go on for a change as the first line comes out. Bond loses it. Egbert has to give it back to him, and now he'll hold it as both teams went on for a change. 9:22 left to go here in this first period. Binghamton gets it up, and now walking in is Jusseau. Walks in the slot against Kennedy. His shot takes a deflection high, goes off the high glass behind the boards, and comes all the way back out to Bond at the near point. Goes cross ice on the far side. A shot from the point is saved by Cavalieri, and he'll cover with 9:06 left to go here in the first period. The Thunderbirds with a 1-0 lead here over the Binghamton Black Bears. We're back to Binghamton after this here on Thunderbirds TV.
Here at Comtech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. Comtech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
We're just over the halfway mark of the first period. 9:06 remains here in the first frame in game two this weekend here from upstate New York. Thunderbirds a 5-4 shootout victory last night, and now trying to take all 3 points here this evening. And Binghamton, consecutive losses for the first time this season. It was Tucker Firth getting on the score sheet to start the scoring for the Thunderbirds just a minute 9 into the game. Thunderbirds have gone on the power play twice here this evening, but are 0-2 so far. So a face-off to the left of Cavalieri. Ford ties up on the ensuing draw, and the Thunderbirds come away with it with Dawson Baker. He just rams one off of the side glass, and it's played by Binghamton out into center ice. Now walking in is Jusseau near dot. Tries to leave one for Thompson, but there was Dawson Baker. Baker now will snap one over on the far side. A big stretch pass as he was trying to get Roman Kramer, but back to collect is Liam Anderson. He'll flip one all the way back out to center ice where Clay Keeley able to play it right back out. As the two sides just kind of play tennis right now, going back and forth. Here's Anderson, plays it back for Jesse Anderson up the far side. Now a snap pass on the near side. Anderson tries to step up. That's Liam Anderson, but he's not able to get there as Baker plays it back out into the neutral zone. Kramer tries to get to Jesse Anderson before it's thrown all the way up on the far side. Here's Ivashkin. He gets poked away by Clay Keeley, and it comes back out to the neutral zone before it's backhanded to Gus Ford. Ford walks in. Thunderbirds are onside. Ford spins, gets tangled up. The official's hand goes up. As this one comes all the way back out, Cavalieri makes his way to the bench. Thunderbirds going to go on the power play for the third time tonight. Tucker Firth walks in. His shot gets deflected into the corner. Bounces back out to Dominic Dumas. Throws him back across the net. And a save by Egbert with Ford right on the doorstep. At the point, Felder. And they're going to say he wasn't able to keep it in. But for the third time tonight, the Thunderbirds are going to be going on a little Italy power play. So the Thunderbirds 0 for 2 here this evening, trying to change that. They're with their third attempt this period. Carolina now 5 for 20 on the season. It'll be Panarchek in against Tyson Kirkby to the left of Egbert. Face off, a tie up, and it comes back out to the point for Joe Kennedy. He plays it to Jan Salak on the near half boards. Gets to the point. Kennedy cross ice to Panarchek. He dances back to Kennedy. Kennedy thinks about a shot. Gets it right back from Salak. He walks in. Fakes. Doesn't have a lane. Leaves it for Salak. Goes cross ice. A one-timer and a save by Egbert. It's backhanded around. Stepping up on the forechecks, Kennedy. He's able to get there as Weaver tried to knock it all the way out. Coming away with it, Dumas. Goes on the far side and back out to the point now. Salak dancing. Sends it over to Panarchek. Walks in hot, top of the slot, and a save by Egbert. Good start to the power play here for the Thunderbirds. Still not clear. Dumas walks in. He just leaves it for Kennedy on the near side. Kennedy walks in, top of the dot. We'll bring it back out. Goes cross ice to Panarchek, who holds to Salak at the near dot. Back out to the point. About a minute to go here on the man advantage. One-timer from the slot, sails high. Salak there, he's able to get to the rebound first. He goes down behind the net after he gets tied up with Weaver. Puck's still loose back there, and it looks like the officials are going to say that Schnott might have played it with his hand. So the Thunderbirds spending the first 65 seconds of that Little Italy power play in the attacking zone. It'll bring up another face-off in the attacking zone. Now they are going to bring it back out. They said the Thunderbirds played it with a hand pass. So it brings it back out to the neutral zone. 55 seconds remain here on the man advantage. After Dustin Jussieu got called for a holding. Face-off is won by Binghamton, and back to play is Fletcher. Fletcher holds, and I'll send this one all the way back down where Tucker Firth will kick it over to Gus Ford as the Thunderbirds try to set up with 43 seconds remaining on the man advantage. On the far side, Baker tries to get this one in deep, but coming away with it and rattling it all the way back down now is Daniel Stone as Cavalieri will play it to his defenseman Tucker Firth here with 30 seconds to go here in the Thunderbirds' third power play of the evening. Firth to the blue line. Here's Gus Ford. Walks into the zone on the near side. Ford spins away at the half boards. Plays it back out to the point for Firth. Firth a shot! And a save by Egbert. It comes out on the far side to Baker. Baker brings it back to the blue line. We'll cycle this one in as Roman Kramer leaves. Ford trying to get there, as well as Kessler Sky before it's cleared all the way back down with 7-6 left to go. Here on the power play, so the Thunderbirds are going to go for to 0-3 tonight as the man has come out of the box, but Gus Ford into the attacking zone, spins around a defender, walks in the slot, shot, save, puck still loose, he tried to get a second attempt, but wasn't able to get it. Now here comes Binghamton, Jesse Anderson up the far side, absorbs a hit from Tucker Firth before it's played back behind the net, and Jacob Schnapp's able to intercept. Schnapp now, he had 2 goals last night, trying to do it again. Schnapp at the near side. He leaves the puck at the point for Nate Keeley, who's able to dance his way in and get it to Schnapp behind the net. Throwing back out in front, that one hit a skate in front. Stanko Hangs it off the back of the cage into the far side. Schnapp applies a good hit there. Puck comes back out to center ice with Ivashkin. Leaves it for Stanko, who left the puck at center ice. Butita picks it up, gets it to Schnapp. Schnapp trying to get it over to Keeley. Keeley stepping up. Butita comes away with it. He spins around at the dot, throws one on net, and it's saved by Egbert. So puck goes high in the air, comes out on the near side. Schnapp's able to send a man to the ground. Binghamton wants a call, but none from the officials. Nate Keeley on the near side. He gets ran into. Before this one's flicked back to the point, Clay Keeley's able to keep it in, but now the puck is taken away. On the far side, man walks in. That's Connor Smith. Circles back, top of the dot, a shot save. Puck still loose in the crease. Cavaliers able to make a save. Comes back out to the high slot, and the shot goes wide, and the net comes off. It's Morix. Boy, Lahr had the chance from the top of the slot as there was a multitude of bodies in the crease. Cavalieri was down, and the net was able to come off its moorings, and that ends the attacking threat for Binghamton. With 4:32 left to go here in the first period, the Thunderbirds, a 1-0 lead over Binghamton here in game two this weekend. We're back after this on Thunderbirds TV.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green, and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
.432 remaining here in the first period from Binghamton. Game two this weekend between the Thunderbirds and the Black Bears. The Comtech shots on goal so far. Carolina 11 and Binghamton 10. Thunderbirds leading 1-0. Thanks for that early goal from Tucker Firth at the 109 mark of the first period. Face-off to the right of Cavalieri after the net came off its moorings. It's a tie-up on the face-off, and the Thunderbirds come away with it on the far side. Gregory Felder, short pass up to Jan Salak, who backhands this one. And Salak leaves it. Now on the near side is Clay Keeley. Sends this one all the way back down. Icing is called off as Weber's back to pick up. Weber. Stretch pass out to the far side. A pass tries to get to Yates, but comes out on the near side. Kirkby and Petita go after it as Salak absorbs a hit at the blue line. Is able to clear back out to center ice for Weber. Recontrols back in his own defensive zone and goes to his defensive pairing. It's played all the way back in. Cavalieri in it. Behind his own net, plays it up to the half boards for Jan Salak with 3:48 remaining here in the first period. A tangle up there over on the far side between Keeley and Thompson. Rather, Felder and Thompson as Salak now at center ice at the blue line. He walks in, fending off a defender. Panacek flips this one high off the glass. It takes a roll up on the top of the boards before Dominic Dumas comes away with it. Here's Jan Salak behind the net. Gets ran into by two Black Bears where the puck squirts free. Dumas is able to duck under a hit and now is being held up at the half boards. Panacek on the far side. Loses the puck as it comes back out to center ice. Popoff just whacks this one over to the far side. This will be rattled all the way back around. Here's your poach. 3 minutes to go here in this first bank first period. Played back out to center ice. Dumas will let this one go as he goes off for a change. Binghamton will walk into the zone with Liam Anderson. Anderson will just throw one in on Cavalieri, who makes a glove save. And he'll freeze with 2:53 remaining here in the first period. Thunderbirds and Gus Ford in for the draw against Brendan Stanko. This will come to the left of Cavalieri as now the linesman comes out and are going to scrape something off the ice here in front of the Black Bears bench. Thunderbirds have been the aggressors so far this season. That early goal, they've gone on the power play three times. thought Binghamton was going to come out pretty fast here in game two after dropping that one last night, but so far, despite the infractions and some extracurriculars, not much for them in the offensive zone. So now the ice is cleared, and we are back to hockey. Ford's tied up on the draw and ends up being tapped back to Clay Keeley with 2:50 left to go here in the first period. On the far side is Roman Kramer. He'll float one back out to center ice where it's whacked down by Connor Smith. This one comes back in on Cavalieri, taps it over to Clay Keeley, who plays it on the near side to his defensive partner, Joe Kennedy. Before Dawson Baker will rattle this one back around and cycle it back as Keeley absorbs a hit, able to angle off a man, but it's left for Stanko. Stanko on the far side gets poke checked. Kramer has it now in the corner. Thunderbirds trying to clear the zone, and Kramer's able to do that as he lifts one all the way back down. This one will go for icing. So long shift for the Thunderbirds coming out of that restart, and now we'll have to keep the same five out there. They couldn't clear the defensive zone. Kirkby wins the draw, gets it back, a quick shot, and that one doesn't get all the way through as it's deflected into the corner and played off the high glass by Joe Kennedy. It's gloved down on the near side by Andrew Logar, who was a scratch last night. Now a big tangle up, and it comes back out to Jesse Anderson. Anderson over to Yates as this one zips off the glass and is backhanded in by Liam Anderson. Aaron Anderson's on this first line of defense. So shot comes back out. Yates whiffs from the top of the dot. Cavalieri makes a save, and now Tyson Kirkby right in front of the net, talking with Gus Ford. These two are just talking a little bit, coming out of that media timeout. But nothing there from the two sides, so 1:53 left to go. Thunderbirds will get a change. They'll bring out the third line with Butsita, Nick Keeley, and Jacob Schnapp, Tucker Firth, and Gregory Felder. Dustin Gisseau in for the draw with Austin Thompson, Andrew Logar, Weber, and Boilar. And gets thrown out, so Logar in for the draw. He's able to win it back to the point. Weaver will set one, throwing in on net. That one gets stuck in the slot. Puck still bouncing around, and a save by Cavalieri. A reaction save there on the near side. Logar throws one off a Schnapp as now it comes out in the near half boards and is rattled back around. Gisseau picks it up on the near side, throws one off. Weird angled shot and a save by Cavalieri. It comes back out to the top of the net. Weber's shot is blocked by Schnapp, and now here come the Thunderbirds. Butsita will throw this one off the linesman. Thunderbirds are onside. Schnapp now in the slide. Backhand's one, and this one gets the deflection over the net. Schnapp was trying to get his third here this weekend. 1:20 to go here in the first period. A 1-0 advantage for Carolina as Firth applies a hit. Now it's Boilar at the blue line. He'll just throw one in on Cavalieri, who makes the save. And he'll freeze with 1:09 remaining here in the first 20. Coming up at the first intermission report, take a look at the first 20 minutes. Also, check around the rest of the FPHL. Coming up in the first intermission report after the next minute and 9 seconds. Faceoff is won by the Thunderbirds. Clay Keeley in the corner. It's poke checked away. It comes back to Joe Kennedy, who plays it off the near boards. And Dominic Dumas tries to control the blue line as we're under a minute to go here in the first period. This one's dumped in on Egbert. He's not it. He makes the save, but it comes out into the near corner. Jan Salak trying to get there, but he's not able to come away with it before it's brought back out to center ice. And going after it now is Clay Keeley. Just whack one back out to the red line as Slock steps through a defender, walks in, leaves it for Panacek, who throws one on net, and a glove save by Egbert. So Thunderbirds trying to get one more here before these final 40 seconds tick off. Both teams scoring within the final 10 seconds of a period last night. Thunderbirds on the second, and then Binghamton in the third. Faceoff to the right of Egbert. It's won by Binghamton. It's rattled around the boards. It comes out on the near side. Here's Gavin Yates across the red line with 30 seconds to go in the first. Yates Walks in, brings it behind the net with Joe Kennedy on him. It's back out to Liam Anderson, who backhands this one to Yates. Yates at the half boards, forgot the puck. Kennedy pokes this one out to the blue line. It's able to be kept in. Kirkby leaves it, throw in the slot. Yates, a shot and a save by Cavalieri. Oh, he's made some big saves here this weekend. And another big one there with 10 seconds to go here in the first period. Dumas will rattle this one in as Salat gets ran into by Kirkby with 4 seconds and 3. And that will do it for the first 20 minutes here in Binghamton. Tucker Firth, his goal coming just 1:09 into this one as the Thunderbirds in front after 20. So the Thunderbirds now will head to the dressing room and try to be able to figure out a way to build on this lead. Second period was a big one last night as Binghamton really dominated it, so the Thunderbirds going to have to try to do their best to try to prevent that again here this evening. We've reached the first intermission. First intermission reports coming up on the other side of this on Thunderbirds TV.
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker, one with big heart. They were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start. From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score. So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
Proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds, Parrish Tire and Automotive, your reliable, local, and honest choice. In Winston-Salem, Mount Airy, Dobson, Jonesville, and Clemens. Go Birds!
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Hi, I'm Wake Wagner with Wagner Appliance, proud supporter of the Thunderbirds. We're a retailer of new, used, and scratch and dent appliances. Our prices do include delivery, installation, all the cords and hoses for most things that we sell. We are also a proud servicer of most of your major brands. Go Birds!
Hey, Michael and Jennifer Anderson with A4 Services. We are proud supporters of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Can't wait to see you all at the Annex. Go Birds!
Back here in Binghamton as we've reached the first intermission with the Thunderbirds leading 1-0 thanks to the goal 1:09 into the game from Tucker Firth with assists from Dominic Dumas and Peter Panacek. Coming at the 1:09 mark, Thunderbirds a 1-0 advantage after the first 20 minutes. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV as we take a look at the first period in this one. So far here tonight, the Thunderbirds being outshot by Binghamton 15-13 over these first 20 minutes. Mario Cavalieri has saved all 15 he's seen here this evening, while Nolan Egbert has given up one on 13 shots. He saved 12 of 13 so far here tonight. All our shots on goal tallies this season are brought to you by Comtech. Saw several penalties in that first period. First, a couple of two-minute minors at the 1:17 mark between Matthew Boilar as well as Peter Panacek. It came at the 1:17 mark, so the two sides played 4-on-4 for the next 2 minutes before got back to 5-on-5 action. It was Nikita Ivashkin at the 5:11 mark. He was calling for a 2-minute roughing minor. Thunderbirds, after they weren't able to get anything on that power play, 6 seconds after that power play had expired, Tyson Kirkby went to the box for 2 minutes for a cross check. And then later on in the first period, Dustin Jussieu was called for a 2-minute hold as the But the Thunderbirds so far here tonight, they have not been able to get anything going on the power play. Their last power play, they're able to set up a lot of zone time, including the first 65 seconds of that final power play of that period. But right now, only the one goal to show for it so far. He knew this game was going to be physical. He knew Binghamton was going to be coming ready to go after taking the 5-4 shootout loss last night. For the Thunderbirds, doing a nice job in that first period, being able to really hold their own. I thought for the better part of that first period, they looked like the better team at times. But last night, it was that second period that you saw Binghamton come out rearing and ready to go. They got two goals to tie it up and really dominated that second period. That's what Steve Harrison said pregame. Then that second period, he told his guys to be ready. And Binghamton came out. They were able to tie it up, but the Thunderbirds came away with a goal late in the second period, took the 3-2 advantage into the third before the Thunderbirds came away with a 5-4 shootout win. So right now, at the first intermission, the Thunderbirds leading the Binghamton Black Bears by a score of 1-0. We'll take a timeout and come back with more and take a look around the rest of the FPHL coming up after this here on Thunderbirds TV.
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day, and when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flow Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Hui.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goals. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
Hey, Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
Or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com, and mention the Thunderbirds, and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
Thank you, Binghamton. As the first intermission report continues right now, Carolina a 1-0 lead after the first 20 minutes over the Binghamton Black Bears. Thunderbirds trying to finish off the sweep and take 5 points here this weekend against the Black Bears, who currently sit at the top of the FPHL and the top of the Empire Division, as well as we take a look at the FPHL standings coming into this evening. See Carolina there with the 4-1-0 record with 11 points, trailing only Mississippi in Columbus in the Continental Division. Binghamton on the other side, 5-0-3, still have not lost in regulation with Motor City right behind them. And remember that earlier this week, it was announced that Blue Ridge and Motor City would switch divisions, with Motor City joining the Empire and Blue Ridge joining the Continental. But three other games going on around the rest of the FPHL this evening, and we'll start with one in Michigan once again. It's the battle of Motor City and Port Huron last night, a 7-1 win for Motor City over Port Huron. That one was at home. This one, it's up in Port Huron here this evening, as they are just about set to get started in the second period in that one. No score between Motor City and Port Huron, despite the Prowlers outshooting the Rockers 18-7. Looking elsewhere throughout the rest of the FPHL here on this Veterans Day, we head to Withville. Blue Ridge and Mississippi back at it, and after the first period, it is all Blue Ridge. They lead Mississippi 6-2. So Blue Ridge is able to hang on. That will help out the Thunderbirds in the standings. if the Thunderbirds are able to take away a victory here this evening. But 6-2, 22-11, the shots on goal in the first period from the Apex Center. Thunderbirds, another home-and-home set against Blue Ridge coming up next weekend before their first matchup against Columbus coming up after Thanksgiving. One other game here this evening is from Elmira. From First Arena with just about 15 minutes remaining in the third period between Danbury and Elmira. It's the hat tricks on the road right now. Third period goal has them in front 4-3. Bodan Zinchenko, he has scored the last two goals of that one for Danbury, who lead 4-3. Danbury only 3-5 to start off the season with 8 points. One of those wins coming against the Thunderbirds. One of the losses as well against Carolina. Elmira and Danbury right there in the middle of that Empire Division. So that's a look around the rest of the FPHL here this evening as we're at the first intermission here in Binghamton. It's a 1-0 advantage for the Thunderbirds over the Binghamton Black Bears. Carolina trying to pick up their fourth straight win before they face off against Blue Ridge coming up next weekend, Friday at the Annex, and then next Saturday back on the road in Wytheville. As those two sides meet 13 times this season, 11 more left to go here in 2023-2024 in Wytheville's inaugural season. So Carolina trying to do something that no one has done yet this season throughout the FPHL and trying to be able to take Binghamton down here 2 times in a row. We'll come back and we'll reset things for the start of the second period. Coming up on the other side of this timeout here on Thunderbirds TV.
Mabel Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad.
Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
Flo Cadillac is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive. Or go online to flowcadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts and we service what we sell. Visit us at riddletractor.com. That's riddletractor.com, equipping those who get the job done. Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker, one with big heart. They were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start.
From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score.
So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
Proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds, Parrish Tire and Automotive, your reliable, local, and honest choice. In Winston-Salem, Mount Airy, Dobson, Jonesville, and Clemens. Go Birds!
Back here in Binghamton, 1-0, the Thunderbirds in front here at the first intermission. Thanks to a goal from Tucker Firth, his first of the season. He's had a pretty good weekend. The St. Thomas, Ontario native has now up to 5 points on the season with 1 goal and 4 assists, playing in his 70th career FPHL game here this evening. Also getting his 10th goal of his FPHL career as well with that goal, with assists from Dominic Dumas and Peter Panacek. Panacek now with 6 assists this season. Most on the Thunderbirds here this season. Also gets his 147th of his FPHL career if you include the postseason. He now is sitting in third in the all-time franchise leaders, trailing only Gus Ford and Jan Solak, his linemate. And Dominic Dumas getting another point here tonight. His second point of his career in his fifth game in pro hockey. Now with two on the season for the Boise, Idaho native Dominic Dumas. Mario Cavalieri, 15 of 15 saves here tonight after he saved 36 of 40 a night ago. This would include that. It's not including three in the shootout. Thunderbirds trying to come away with another victory here this evening here against this Binghamton Black Bears side, who have been the hottest team coming out of the gates here in 2023-2024. But last night also, Gus Ford, he has continued to climb the leaderboards, and now just 114 regular season games. Gus Ford moved into second all-time in Thunderbirds history in points while also being the franchise leader in goals. 206 points in his career as a Thunderbird, as well as finding the back 94 times. He is only six away from 100 regular season goals. He had one last night. He had a couple last weekend and a couple the weekend before that. He's already got five goals here this year so far. So the Thunderbirds right now leading 1-0 over the Binghamton Black Bears here on Veterans Day here in upstate New York. Once again, thank you to all of those who have served and continue to serve our great country that has allowed for us to be able to enjoy this game here tonight and all the other freedoms that we have here in the United States. Good first 20 minutes, should be another exciting middle 20 minutes. Thunderbirds trying to be able to put a stamp on this one and trying to come out and trying to be able to start to pull away from the Binghamton Black Bears. Carolina has won six in a row in this series, trying to make it seven here tonight. We're back with the second period after this from Binghamton on Thunderbirds TV.
Hey Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
Or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com, and mention the Thunderbirds and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. ComTech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more. Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allentown.com.
Back here in Binghamton, again set for the start of the second period. It is brought to you by Flow Automotive. Carolina 1-0 goal or lead, thanks to the Tucker Firth goal coming early on in the first period after he was able to find one after a scramble in front of the net. As the Thunderbirds in front, as we get set to start the second period, the period of the long change. As Carolina will be going right to left, Binghamton will be going left to right. Mario Cavalieri saving 15 of 15 in that first frame. On the other side, it was Nolan Egbert saving 12 of 13 shots that he saw. So we are set to go for the start of the second here in Binghamton. Gus Ford in for the faceoff with Tyson Kirkby. And the second period is underway from the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. 1-0 lead. Here's an early chance for Binghamton. Spinning around, sending on the near side's Matt Lewis over to Yates, who gets it back to the point. Stone back to Yates on the near side. Back out in Stone. Walks the blue line. They'll just send this one back in. We're back to collect as Lewis going against Joe Kennedy, who was able to evade a hit. There's Kirkby, a goal last night for him. Puck's back out at the point. Lewis now will leave the puck. Kennedy's able to get there. He gets ran into in the boards behind the net. Kennedy going one on two as now Yates comes away with it. Puck still being jammed around there behind the net. Before Kennedy's finally just able to kick one out into the far corner. And it comes back out to the point once again. Here's Weber, a shot that doesn't get all the way through. It's still loose in the slot. Baker is able to poke one out. Comes back out to the blue line, but not cleared. On the far side, walking in, a shot and a save by Cavalieri. So the first 55 seconds of this first period, the Thunderbirds have been in their defensive zone. They have not been able to clear it. Second period was controlled by Binghamton last night. You know they were going to come out hot here once again. Thunderbirds trying to get a good counter here. Now the faceoff comes to the right of Mario Cavalieri, and it's won by the Thunderbirds and into the corner now. Gregory Felder loses the puck, bounces up to Ivashkin, who battles for it in the corner. Going up against Felder, Ivashkin comes away with it, comes on the near side, throws one in the slot, and it's able to be clear, but only over to Dominic Dumas, and it's back into the corner. Ivashkin once again throws one in the slot, and Stanko, he wasn't able to get there in time. Thunderbirds will now flip this one back out to center ice and clear. So an early sustained attacking zone pressure here from Binghamton. Tucker Firth backtracks, plays it up to Salak. Thunderbirds are onside as he leaves it for Dumas. Dumas walks in, top of the dot, a shot, and that one's deflected wide as Dumas goes colliding into the corner. Puck at the blue line now. It'll be whacked out to center ice. It'll be rattled all the way around the boards. It'll come out into the near half boards. Ivashkin gets there first, and before he gets hammered into the boards by Jan Salak. But the official's arm went up, and Salak's going to make his way to the penalty box. So for the first time tonight, the Thunderbirds are going to go on the penalty kill. 15 for 18 this year, good for 83%, while on the other side, 10 for 40, 25% for Binghamton. Faceoff comes to the right of Cavalieri. It's won by the Black Bears. Here's Thompson, walks in, top of the dot, a shot, and that one sails high and wide on the far side. Yates isn't able to keep it in as it comes back out to center ice. They call it a hold on Salak. As the Thunderbirds trying to kill off a power play here for the first time this evening. Up the far side, it's Tyson Kirkby. He had a goal last night, sends one cross corner to Lewis. Plays on the backhand back to Thompson at the blue line. Sends it back into the zone. A tap pass over the far side. Sent one into the slot. Kirkby couldn't get there, but Thompson's able to collect. 5-on-4 action for the next minute, 26th. On the near side, Kirkby tries to send one cross ice. Takes a deflection. Kennedy's able to knock it down, but they're not able to clear. Thompson walking in. Cross ice. Far dot. Yates walks in. Tries to send one across for Kirkby. Gets deflected back out. And Schnapp's able to lay out the body as he gets a big block. And it comes all the way back out to center ice. Schnapp hurting there as he makes his way back to the bench. Gus Ford comes back out. Yates leaves it on the far side. Kirkby back to Yates. And they score. Well, last night, Binghamton needed to go 6-on-4. To try to be able to come away with a pair of goals late. They scored 3 goals on the power play last night. And now on their first try here tonight, it's Gavin Yates tying us up at 1. Here with 17-11 left to go in the second period. We knew they were going to come out fast in the middle 20. They did it last night. And so now we are back to a brand new game. It's back to 5-on-5 action. As Tucker Firth in his own defensive zone gets poke check. And now here come the Black Bears again. Stanko walks in. A shot and a save by Cavalieri. Puck still loose though in the slot. And it trickles out on the near side. Still in the corner. Man goes down. Goes all the way to the far side. Official's hand never went up. But Stanko gets it back to the point. Bond dances in. Into the far corner. Stanko back out to the point. Connor Smith sends one cross ice. Bond walks in, a shot save. Rebound still loose, though, and this one takes a deflection and goes into the protective netting. Right now it is all Binghamton. Here over these first 3.5 minutes. As now it looks like Steve Harrison is going to use his timeout. with 16:36 remaining in this second period. Steve Harrison, after what was a fast start for Binghamton, a goal, and now another prime scoring opportunity. He's going to buy his team a minute to try to be able to reset here, catch their breath, try to figure out how to attack Binghamton, who have come out quickly. Schnapp looks to be all right, skating around after he was able to get a block there on the penalty kill, but he came up moving gingerly back to his bench. But it looks like he's going to be all right. He'll stay on the bench. Thunderbirds already a man down here tonight, with Curtis Hagee taking a hit last night in the second period. He'll go under further evaluations when the team returns to Winston-Salem. But Jussot and Ford in for the draw. There's the tie-up, and Ford's able to win it as the Thunderbirds now try to clear their own zone. Kramer will backhand this one to Gregory Felder. Goes defensive pairing Tucker Firth as they go right back and forth with each other. Here's Kramer. Throws one up. That one goes off the skate of Baker. Baker will be the first one back there, so icing wouldn't have mattered anyway. Baker tries to throw it on net, but ends up going off the back of the net as Ford now tied up in the corner. Throws a man into the boards, but coming away with it is Bond. Ford's played out on the near side with Thompson, who goes cross ice. It goes off the boards, and Firth just plays it back to the blue line, but Bond stepping up, he'll bring it into the zone. Bond leaves it for Thompson. The near half boards, a shot and a block in front by Feller, took it right off the chest. And now he comes away with it, walking up the ice. 15:52 left to go here in the second period. We're tied up at one. Kramer makes a man go down to the ice as now he goes into the behind the net and ends up losing the puck. And now puck still bouncing around. Jussot with it on his stick across center ice and into the attacking zone. Loses the puck as Firth now is able to backhand this one back out as he takes a hit from Jussot. Ford trickles back down. 15:30 left to go here in the second period. It was a goal from Tucker Firth in the first period that made it 1-0 in favor of the Thunderbirds. Then Binghamton on the power play here in this second period, tying it at one. Up the far side, Dumas plays this one back behind the net. The second line out here for the Thunderbirds, but now here comes Binghamton with Kirkby. Leaves it for Yates across the blue line, walks in top of the dot, a shot and a save by Cavalieri. Strong save there from Mario Cavalieri. Nice job squaring up, being able to get it right in the chest, right in that script, Carolina. Now face off to the left of him. Kirkby and Panacek in for the draw. Face off, the tie up. Yates comes away with it, walks into the slot, leaves it back at the point. Throwing on front, that one took a deflection, still loose in the slot, banging around, still loose, and Cavalieri somehow able to find it, and he's able to cover with 14:55 left to go. Mac Lewis lost his helmet. It looks like that is going to be it. So 14:55 remains here in the middle period. Binghamton tying it up over the first 5 minutes. We're tied at one here as we've reached a media timeout. We're back after this here on Thunderbirds TV.
Here at Comtech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. Comtech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Here in the second period, we're tied at one between Binghamton and Carolina. Gavin Yates at the 2:49 mark on the power play has tied us up at one with assists from Tyson Kirkby and Jesse Anderson. So now a defensive zone faceoff for the Thunderbirds. Just to the left of Mario Cavalieri, Kirkby and Panacek in for the draw. Faceoff is won by Kirkby, gets it back to Yates, goes cross ice on the far side and gets it right back at the point. On the near side now, Boylar will throw one and snap one high over the net. It comes back out. Yates isn't able to keep it in, and so Thunderbirds are able to hold there. Boylar now back in his own defensive zone, goes cross ice to Yates. Saucer one out to center ice as Lewis walks in to the far half boards. Drops it back for Yates. Yates now runs right into Jan Salak before spinning away. Kirkby brings it behind the net. Nice shot there by Clay Keeley being able to run him off. As the puck now tied up between five guys, it comes out into the corner. Salak against Yates as Yates tries to angle him off, but Salak's able to come away with it with Jordan Popoff stepping in as well. Popoff now with it at the half boards, loses the puck, is able to just poke it back. Thunderbirds really having a tough time being able to clear, but now here's an odd man chance. Here comes Kessler Sky in on Looney, scores! Oh, the Black Bears get caught in a line change. The defenseman went off, and Kessler Sky gets his first professional goal in all alone as he's able to snap one that goes over the shoulder of Nolan Egbert. And the Thunderbirds have regained the lead. It's 2-1. What a find by Jan Salak. Sky was just waiting out in the neutral zone, and they're able to catch Binghamton making a mistake, and the Thunderbirds once again lead 2-1. Now can the Thunderbirds carry this momentum? Joe Kennedy loses the puck in the slot, a shot and a save by Cavalieri. Puck still loose though, scramble for it. Cavalieri's in the splits, it ends up behind the net. Smith plays it to Ivashkin, brings it back, throws one across the crease. Kennedy is able to whack it into the corner and into the half boards, and Butina now is able to clear the zone up to Nate Keeley. Keeley over the blue line, rattles this one around the boards. Egbert will send this one high off the glass to Connor Smith at the blue line. 13:23 remains in the second period. Kessler Sky sending the Thunderbirds back in front. Ivashkin on the far side, behind the net to Jesse Anderson. It comes back in front. Cavalier is able to hug his post and is able to fall on it. And he freezes as now Tucker Firth. It's tangled up there with Nikita Ivashkin. Ivashkin's been in the middle of a lot here so far this evening. But Kessler Sky with a Riddle Tractor goal coming at the 5:59 mark of the second period with assists from Jan Salak and Jordan Popoff. As the Thunderbirds in front, here with 13:12 remaining in this second period. Gus Ford in for the draw. It's won by Gisso. Back out to the point and played up against the half boards. Puck battling around. Clay Keeley whacks this one off the glass. Dawson Baker now has it. After Firth took a hit, this one comes all the way back out to center ice after it's skied high in the air and on the near side now. Puck will come all the way back in. No icing, it's waved off. And tries to step through, but Tucker Firth comes away with it, plays it back in front of his own net as Baker tries to find four, but now here's a chance and a save by Cavalieri. Puck still bouncing around, and another one as it comes out on the near side. Kramer now at the near side. It's played by Jusso behind the net after it's taken away. Good hit there by Firth as he sends a man down to the ground. Here's a shot, takes a deflection off of Baker and comes out into the near half boards. Kramer's able to come away with it. Only for a second, though, is back out to the point. A one-timer. That one blocked in the slot. Puck still loose, and Cavalieri is able to get a glove to it and cover. And now a hit after the whistle and more tie-ups. And it looks like Tucker Firth is going to be called for an infraction. So for the second time tonight, the Thunderbirds are going to be going on the penalty kill. Binghamton, their lone goal here tonight, has come on the power play. It's Firth applied a hit down right in front of the crease after there's a bunch of bodies all around. And now Tucker Firth into the penalty box. 2 minutes are up on the clock. 12:16 remaining. Faceoff is won by the Black Bears. On the near side, Thompson back out to the point. It's Jesse Anderson over the far side. Puck thrown into the slot. Kirkby, he gets jammed by a few. It's a clearing attempt, but not clear. Thompson now. Cross ice on the far side, back to Anderson at the blue line, who gets it right back to Thompson. He walks in a shot, and a save by Cavalieri, though. Puck still loose, though. Brought behind the net by Kirkby. Another big save by Mario Cavalieri. Well, the Thunderbirds now trying to clear the zone on the far side. It's Yates. Back out to the point. Jesse Anderson to Thompson. Walks in, and a glove save by Cavalieri. He had a man right in front of him, and he was still able to snag that one. Saw it all the way despite the screen, and he covers with 1:25 remaining. You're on the penalty kill for the Thunderbirds. Four of the five goals this weekend for Binghamton have come with either a man or two men up. Two of them coming in 6-on-4 last night over the final 3 minutes, and a power play goal in the middle period yesterday. Face-off comes back out to the point. Anderson backhands this one down to Lewis in the corner. He's got Gregory Felder on him, leaves it for Kirkby, who gets it back out to Thompson. Goes cross ice on the far side. Yates walk into the half boards, walks into the net. Surveys, spins, and brings it back out. Anderson now a shot. That one gets deflected in front, battling around. Puck still loose. Boutita is able to get a stick there and gets it up to Ford. Ford trying to clear the zone. He's able to clear it, and now he just goes after a man before it's brought right back in. Yates walks in. A shot, and that one's blockered away by Cavalieri. Puck comes back out to the side of the net, and he's able to cover with 11:06 remaining and 50 seconds on the 5-on-4 power play for Binghamton. Tucker Firth having to wait another 50 seconds after a roughing call at the 7:44 mark. Ensuing faceoff to the right of Cavalieri is a tie-up. Popoff whacks it back out to the point. Now here's Stenko. Stenko cycles, goes to the far side to Connor Smith. We'll bring it back to the top of the slot. A shot and a save by Cavalieri. Cavalieri is seeing everything tonight. Made 36 saves last night, and our Comtech shots on goal so far with 10:53 remaining in this second period. Binghamton, 31 shots. Carolina, only 14. But the Thunderbirds still in front. On the far side, Smith with Schnapp coming after him. Goes down low to Ivashkin. Back out to the point. Man walks across the blue line. Schnapp gets another block. Bond now, top of the dot, throws one. A centering pass, and that one's deflected up into the netting. I'm going to say a last touch, a Thunderbird, so we'll bring up a face-off to the right of Mario Cavalieri. Face-off is won by Binghamton. On the near side, Stenko surveys, goes cross ice. Smith back to Bonn, a one-timer. It's blocked by Schnapp again. He's had a few here tonight, but it's not cleared. Played off the back boards, back out to Stenko at the near point. 6 seconds left to go. A shot, and that one hits a man in front. 3 seconds and 2. The centering pass comes wanting out to the near side. Weaver stepping up on the forecheck. The penalty kill is over, but here's Gisseau. Gisseau, a shot. That one's blocked in front, and it's deflected back out to the point before it's batted back around. Ivashkin comes out into the near side. It's poked away. Firth, who just came out of the box, joining the defensive zone. Ivashkin spins around the net. Puck still battling around. Coming out near side. Gisseau tries to throw it in. Cavalieri makes a save. Puck's loose in the crease. He can't find it. Squirts free, and it's poked away by Gregory Felder. Comes out to the near half boards. Weaver. Cross ice. Gisseau at the near dot. Throws one. That one goes wide. It goes off the back of the cage. A Black Bear still able to come away with it, though, on the far side. Weaver back out to the point. Bond goes near side. Gisseau. With 9:27 remaining. Gets a stick lifted by Firth. Gisseau will bring it back behind the net. Back out to the point. Weaver, a one-timer. That one doesn't get all the way through. Comes back out to the top of the dot. And now walking over the near side is Connor Smith. Smith surveys his shot. Goes high off the glass. Bond, though, comes away with it once again. Thunderbirds cannot clear the zone. You can tell they are gassed. Here's Gisseau trying to walk into the slot. Schnapp down on the ice. He's able to clear it up. Fletcher comes away with it. Back out to the point. Weaver goes far side to Fletcher. Back out into the slot. Smith, he whiffs on the attempt. Schnapp doesn't have his stick. A shot goes high and wide. Cavalieri never saw it before Firth runs into a man on the near side. Still not clear. In the slot. A shot, it's blocked by Schnapp again. The Thunderbirds will just clear where Egbert will play it. As now the Thunderbirds, they're still not even to get off for a full change despite desperately needing it. Thompson, right at the blue line, walks in, leaves it for Logar. Logar throws one on net, and that one takes a deflection on the near side. Dominic Dumas, who just came off the bench, he's the only man with fresh legs right now, will play this one high off the glass. Now Keeley comes to the bench. A backhand in, walking up the far side. Thompson, a shot and a save by Cavalieri. And he'll cover with 8:15 remaining here in the second period. Carolina, a 2-1 lead despite being outshot 33-14. They get a much needed break. And we'll be back after this. Carolina in front, 2-1 here on Thunderbirds TV.
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day, and when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flo Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Hui.
I'm Wake Wagner with Wagner Appliance, proud supporter of the Thunderbirds. We're a retailer of new, used, and scratch and dent appliances. Our prices do include delivery, installation, all the cords and hoses for most things that we sell. We are also a proud servicer of most of your major brands. Go Birds!
Face off to the right of Mario Cavalieri. He's able to withstand a huge onslaught. Puck comes back. Yeah, a shot goes off the post. Oh, a shot from the point from Anderson. Rings the pipe. As now here come the Thunderbirds quickly up the other way. A shot and a save by Egbert. And he'll cover with 8:03 remaining. Oh, Mario Cavalieri has his best friend there. As the shot rings off the pipe from Jesse Anderson. What a good lane, but Cavalieri. And the Thunderbirds able to clear their zone. So now an offensive zone faceoff to the left of Egbert. Panacek fights for it in the corner with Dumas. It's played back out to the point. Jordan Popoff goes near side to Clay Keeley. We'll just rattle this one and cycle the puck in. Panacek gets bumped off the puck on the near side. Now a tie up in the corner. Salak fighting for it. He's able to get there. As now back into the corner goes Dominic Dumas. Spins away from the defender. Throws one into the slot. It's left for Salak. Salak trying to step through. Walks in. And now here comes Binghamton as Popoff will run into a man and throw him down. And a hand goes up for a penalty. Jordan Popoff is going to be called for a penalty. After it was dumped in. He applied a hit, and it looked fine from up here. As Gus Ford now wants an explanation, and rightfully so. Because now the Thunderbirds are going to have to go back on the penalty kill. So once again, Thunderbirds penalty kill back to work. On the near side, Thompson gets it to Anderson at the point. Goes far side to Yates. They call an interference. Thompson. Cross ice, Yates walks in and at the dot, a centering pass, and that one gets deflected all the way off the glass. Thompson controls, shot coming after him before it's played back to Jesse Anderson. Anderson back to Thompson, into the corner, Kirkby. Kirkby on the backhand, brings it back down, interception by Nate Keeley, who clears it down 200 feet. 30 seconds here, into the penalty kill. Under 7 minutes to go in the second period, the Thunderbirds a 2-1 lead over the Binghamton Black Bears. Thanks to Kessler Sky's first professional goal. Yates walks in, circles behind the net, spins away from Felder before getting it back behind the cage. Backhands it over to Stenko. Stenko with Batita on him, leaves it for Kirkby, back to Anderson. Near side now, Gesso at the dot. Tries to send one across the slot, it takes a deflection and comes back out to the neutral zone, where Anderson will have to reset here with 54 seconds to go on the 2 minute minor against Jordan Popoff. Played back, Anderson across center ice. Goes far side, goes off the skate of a man. Now into the corner goes Clay Keeley. Spins away as now he throws a huge hit on a man there in the far corner. Before it comes back out though. Smith comes out to the point. Bond near side to Stenko. Stenko surveying back to Bond. Bond far side, a shot and a save by Cavalieri as Smith was going for a second goal this weekend. Still not cleared though. Bond with 20 to go on the man advantage. Stenko walks in, leaves it Back behind the net, Bond now, cross ice, Smith will just send this one wide intentionally. Clay Keeley's able to step in there, a tie-up, puck bouncing around, comes back out to Smith at the half boards. 8 seconds to go on the power play for Binghamton on the far side. Walking in, a shot, that one goes high, didn't get all the way in. And now a whistle and a stoppage. That's making his way back into the box is Jordan Popoff. That one looks like it went up high and it caught Stenko. The shot from just so. Took a deflection, and it looks like he got him up high. Now Brendan Stenko, the Howell, Michigan native, who has 16 points this season, down on a knee just to the right of Mario Cavalieri. The Thunderbirds able to kill off that penalty. Faceoff is going to come back out to the neutral zone as Stenko gets back up to his feet and skates his way back over to the bench. This game's been physical tonight, a lot more physical than it was last night for a majority of that one. Is that, looking at the replay, I think it went off a skate or a stick. So now neutral zone faceoff. Gus Ford in for the draw with the first line. Kennedy, after the faceoff win by Ford, gets it to Firth, who plays it off the skate of Dawson Baker. This one trickles into the corner where Dan Weber gets around Baker, plays on the backhand on the near side to Boylar. Boylar loses the puck but gets it back, bangs it up. Now a stretch pass goes all the way off the boards, comes all the way down. This should go for icing, and it will. So a 5:07 remaining here in the second period, and the Thunderbirds a 2-1 lead, despite being outshot 34-15. Have an offensive zone faceoff, trying to add to their advantage. Shot on goal tally, brought to you by Comtech. Ford in for the draw, it's one, and it's a snapshot from Baker that sails high. Firth will rattle this one and cycle it all the way back down. It's hopped over the stick of Roman Kramer and into the corner now. Binghamton trying to walk out of the zone, and they will now. As walking up the near side is Weber. Across the red line and into the attacking zone. He flips one into the corner. Cavalieri way out of his crease. Goes cross side to Kennedy, who plays it off the glass, and Ford comes away with it. He spins away, gets it to Baker. Baker now walks in. Here's Dawson Baker dancing through, and his shot just goes wide on the far side. Kramer giving chase with Weber. Going up right against him, but coming away with it is Binghamton. And now on a stretch pass out to the zone. It'll be flipped in cross ice. Tucker Firth plays it off the boards. Kramer trying to get there first. Kirkby got there though. Puck thrown in front. There Firth is able to pick it up. We have another whistle. And it looks like Mario Cavalieri's net came off of its moorings. 4:16 remains here in the second period in Binghamton. Thunderbirds a 2-1 lead thanks to Kessler Skye's first goal of his career. We're back after this on Thunderbirds TV.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
.416 remains here in the second period. Thunderbirds a 2-1 lead over the Binghamton Black Bears in a defensive zone faceoff for the Thunderbirds after Mario Cavalieri's net came off of its pegs. It'll be Peter Panacek in with a big defensive zone draw against Tyson Kirkby in the second game this weekend. Face off to the right of Cavalieri. And it's one. Find the Thunderbirds into the corner. It's played all the way on the near side to Roman Kramer. Played out to center ice. Kessler Sky will chase in against Jesse Anderson. He's able to try to angle him off, but it gets poked away and comes out on the near side now. Jan Salak stepping up on the forecheck. Panacek comes away with it. Back out to the point. Firth a shot and a glove save by Egbert. That only the third shot on goal this period for the Thunderbirds. After they had 13 over the first 20 minutes, they've only had three, but one of those a goal from Kessler Sky. That gave Carolina the 2-1 advantage once again. An attacking zone faceoff. Haven't said much of that here in the second period. Tie up on the faceoff. Salaka shot coming off of the draw. Goes wide, but he gets to it first over on the far half board. Salak with Yates on him. Tie up in the corner as Salak's able to win the battle for a second. Sky comes away with it. Dances to Salak behind the net. Out into the near side. Salak gets ran into by Lewis for another tie up in the near corner with 3:35 remaining here in the second period. They jam after it in the corner. Four bodies there before it finally bounces free over to Jesse Anderson. Anderson will bring it out of his own defensive zone and into the neutral zone before snapping one in cross corner where Tucker Firth back to play it. Plays it only as far as the half boards though as this puck comes back in. Lewis trying to get a stick to it. Ends up going into the corner. Coming away with it now is Panacek. Walks it up into the attacking zone. I'll just snap one in. It goes into the body of Anderson before Panacek is able to get back to it. Kessler Sky now gets ran into by two camo sweaters. Still bouncing around, and it's back down to the point. Felder walks in at the top of the dot, trying to leave it, and now gets checked off at the half boards before Jesse Anderson plays over the far side, trying to go for Liam Anderson. Popoff steps up on the forecheck. Butsita just tries throwing back out in front. It's intercepted and played back out into the neutral zone. And a whistle. With 2:37 remaining here in this second period. Looks like it was played with a high stick. So the Thunderbirds are going to get an attacking zone face-off with Nick Keeley, Jacob Schnapp, and John Butsita. Jordan Popoff and Gregory Felder, the defensemen. Stanko back out on the ice after he took a puck off of the face earlier in this one. Face-off is won by Stanko, a tie-up. It's backhanded only as far as Butsita, though. He rattles it back around the boards behind the net where Bond plays it. Back out to Smith. Backhands this one high off the glass, comes back all the way in. Ivashkin going up against Felder in the corner, throws one in front, and a good poke check there by Mario Cavalieri. So it comes back out to center ice, and it's cleared. Now Butsita in a foot race, so it's Smith trying to angle him off. Keeley stepping up, but coming away with it is Smith, who gets it back, but Schnapp picks his pocket and goes cross ice. Keeley does, up to Butsita. Butsita tries to leave it back for Popoff, but there Stanko gets back, and Joe Kennedy comes away with it as we're under 2 minutes to go here in the second period. A 2-1 advantage for the Thunderbirds. Despite being on the penalty kill for a lot of this second period, it comes all the way back down. Stone. Baker on him, floats one out to center ice. Ivashkin into the attacking zone for Binghamton. Going against Kennedy, throws one in on the near side. Goes off the side of the net. Before it bounces back out, and here's Weber at the point. He walks in, a shot, and that one's saved by Cavalieri. It looked like it took a deflection in front, but Cavalieri is positioning there. He's able to make the save, and he's able to freeze. It's been a busy night for Mario Cavalieri. And it saves 34 of 35. He only faced 40 shots in 65 minutes last night. Faceoff is won by the Black Bears. It's played into the corner where it ricochets back out. Boylard can't keep it in. As he plays it back out center ice and goes to his D partner, Dan Weber. Baker's able to keep it out of the zone, but only for a second, as now it looks like Binghamton is offside. Nice shot there by Dawson Baker, being able to disrupt Binghamton. Going into the attacking zone. Lee Jussot and Ford in for the draw. Just outside the Thunderbirds' defensive zone. Faceoff is won by Jussot. With 1:13 remaining in the second period. Puck comes all the way out to the near half boards. Keeley's able to hold off a man before Kramer throws it off the stick of Ford. Takes a deflection and goes all the way back down on Egbert. Back behind his own net is Dan Stone. Played out on the near side now. Quickly moving up the ice is Dustin Jussieu. With under a minute to go here in the second period, Jussieu into the corner, spins back. Boylar walks in, a shot, and that one's deflected and blocked in front by Clay Keeley, who's battling in the corner. Puck comes loose to Baker. He rattles it all the way around. This one will come all the way back out to center ice. No icing after the man, Weaver, wasn't able to get there in time. 30 seconds remain here in the second period. Thunderbirds a 2-1 lead thanks to Kessler Sky's first goal of his career. On the far side, sent all the way back in. Kennedy will chase after it with 20 to go here in the second. Kennedy will now hold to the right of Cavalieri for bringing it back behind his own net with 13 seconds. Kennedy holds. Binghamton looks like they're going to be content sending this one to the dressing rooms. It's now on the near side. Clay Keeley snaps this one all the way up to Dumas, and that will do it for the second period. As now Dumas throws a man down, and now he got more coming up over in the far corner. Dumas just threw Jesse Anderson down to the ground, and now you got only a few white sweaters down with a lot of camo. As now two guys are going after it there in the corner. Looks like Jan Salat caught in the middle of it. His helmet's been ripped off as Mac Lewis has having a conversation with him. Salak and Boylar still talking. So now the officials are trying to tell everyone to get to their dressing rooms. No one's left their benches yet. A good check there by Dominic Dumas right before, or right after the horn sounded. We'll have to see if that will set the tone for the third period as now both sides make their way to their dressing rooms. Binghamton tied it up on the power play. It was Gavin Yates being able to find one past Mario Cavalieri at the 2:49 mark. But then 3 minutes later, Kessler Sky, his first goal of his pro career as the Thunderbirds in front after the first 40 minutes here in Binghamton. Second intermission report is coming up on the other side of this timeout. Here on Thunderbirds TV.
Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. ComTech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Hey, Mike
Lindsay. Hello, Cadillac Anderson is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds.
We are proud supporters of the Carolina
Visit
Thunderbirds.
Visit 1400.
Can't wait to see you all at the Annex. Go, Birds.
Mabel Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad.
Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
Of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive or go online to flowcadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
What's up, everybody? My name is Zach Taylor, and I'm the owner of Little Donuts. We're a mini donut food truck company specializing in apple cider mini donuts, traveling all over, setting up at different events. This year, I'm happy to announce that we are a proud partner of the Carolina Thunderbirds, and we're going to be set up inside the Annex building all season long at every home game. So while you're out supporting your favorite hockey team, swing by and warm up with some hot, fresh apple cider mini donuts made on site right when you order. Thank you. Hope you have a great day, and go Birds.
Hey, Michael and Jennifer Anderson with A4 Services. We are proud supporters of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Can't wait to see you all at the Annex. Go Birds.
Hey, Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
Or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com, and mention the Thunderbirds, and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where technology.
Back here in Binghamton as our second intermission report rolls along. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV after what was an interesting middle 20 minutes. Thunderbirds outshot 20-3 over those middle 20 minutes, but they hold a 2-1 lead over the Binghamton Black Bears thanks to Kessler Skye's first career goal coming at the 5:59 mark with assists from Jan Salak and Jordan Popoff. As a reminder, all our goals this season are brought to you by Riddle Tractor. Thunderbirds getting their first one at the 109 mark in the first period. Tucker Firth, after a scramble around the net, he was able to walk in and be able to slot one home. Gave Carolina a 1-0 lead for the next about 21 and a half minutes before Gavin Yates tied it at the 2:49 mark of the second period with assists from Tyson Kirkby and Jesse Anderson for Kessler Skye's goal. Puts the Thunderbirds back in front despite being outshot 35-16 here over the first 40 minutes. Our shot on goal tally this season is brought to you by Comtech. So the Thunderbirds, after spending a lot of that second period on the penalty kill, there's a pair of unsportsmanlike conducts, one against Jesse Anderson and one against Jan Salak, that came after the buzzer sounded, after Dominic Dumas threw Anderson down to the ground. He took exception to that, so both are called for unsportsmanlike conduct, so let's see if they are offsetting. Coming out and have to see if it'll be 5-on-5 action. Well, right now, the Thunderbirds in front trying to do something that no team has done yet this season, take two consecutive games against this Binghamton Black Bears side. Mario Cavalieri, he's been great tonight. 34 saves on 35 shots. This is the most action he's seen over the first two periods of a game this year. Saved 36 of 40 last night, not including saving all three in the shootout. On the other side, Nolan Egbert, who's making his first appearance since October 28th against Watertown. He saved 14 of 16 shots here this evening. So an interesting first 40 minutes. We'll take a look around and update you on scores around the rest of the FBHL. Coming up on the other side of this timeout here on Thunderbirds TV.
Flo Cadillac is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive. Or go online to flowcadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goals. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
What's up, everybody? My name is Zach Taylor, and I'm the owner of Little Donuts. We're a mini donut food truck company specializing in apple cider mini donuts, traveling all over setting up at different events. This year, I'm happy to announce that we are a proud partner of the Carolina Thunderbirds, and we're gonna be set up inside the Annex building all season long at every home game. So while you're out supporting your favorite hockey team, swing by and warm up with some hot, fresh apple cider mini donuts made on site right when you order. Thank you. Hope you have a great day, and go Birds.
Thank you, Binghamton. As we continue on the second intermission report, Thunderbirds a 2-1 advantage over the Binghamton Black Bears. Time to take a look around of the rest of the FBHL this evening. As we update you on the standings once again coming into tonight, but we can say that Danbury has added 3 points to that tally after they pick up a 6-5 win over the Elmira River Sharks, just about 45 minutes or so away from where we are here in Binghamton, New York. So Danbury, they improved to 4-5-0 on the year. They get up to 11 points, now trailing Motor City and Binghamton in that Empire Division. Elmira drops to 3-3. Elsewhere around the rest of the FBHL here on Veterans Day and Saturday night, throughout the rest of the league, we head to Wytheville. The Blue Ridge Bobcats in action against the Mississippi Seawolves, and they're just about to start that third period at the Apex Center. And how about 6 first period goals for Blue Ridge? They lead 8-2 after 40 minutes as they're getting set to start the third there from the Apex Center. 40-31, the shots in favor of Blue Ridge, so and it's just been a good night for them offensively. Thunderbirds will see them next weekend in a home-and-home set. Friday at the Annex, Saturday back in Wytheville. So 8-2 the score there going into the final 20 minutes at the Apex Center. And then one other game going on right now. It is in Port Huron up in Michigan at McMoran Arena after a 7-1 win last night for Motor City at home. On the road now in Port Huron, they trail 2-0 after 40 minutes. Port Huron out shooting Motor City 34-20. Goal from Brandon Picard and Brian Parsons, both coming in the second period. One of those coming with just 6 seconds remaining in the frame. As Port Huron in front, you see Port Huron there with 6 points on the season. They're trying to pick up 7, 8, and 9 here tonight. Thunderbirds at 11 points. A win here tonight will send the Thunderbirds back in front. A win of any kind, that is, will send the Thunderbirds into second place. And a win in regulation would have them only 1 point behind Columbus, who is idle here on Saturday evening. Right now, the Thunderbirds, a 2-1 lead over the Binghamton Black Bears. Kessler Sky at the 5:59 mark, his first professional goal for the Canisius product. As the Thunderbirds in front, 2-1, will reset things for the start of the third period. Coming up on the other side of this here on Thunderbirds TV.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day, and when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flo Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Hui.
Hi, I'm Mike Wagner with Wagner Appliance, proud supporter of the Thunderbirds. We're a retailer of new, used, and scratch and dent appliances. Our prices do include delivery, installation, all the cords and hoses for most things that we sell. We are also a proud servicer of most of your major brands. Go Birds!
Go Goals from Gavin Yates and Kessler Sky in that second period have the Thunderbirds with a 2-1 advantage over the Binghamton Black Bears. After tonight, the Thunderbirds home and home against Wittsville before a home and home set after Thanksgiving against the Columbus River Dragons. First time that the Thunderbirds will see Columbus before they see them four consecutive times, spanning from December 23rd all the way into December 31st. Four straight games, three of those at home. That one will be Ugly Sweater Night, brought to you by Halo Lighting, coming up on December 23rd, December 29th on the road in Columbus, and then the 30th and the 31st, both at home. That New Year's Eve game, an 8:35 puck drop, where the puck then, if you're at the annex last week and that was suspending over center ice, will be dropped at center ice. It's a representative ball drop. The third period coming up next. Here from Binghamton after this.
What's up, everybody? My name is Zach Taylor, and I'm the owner of Little Donuts. We're a mini donut food truck company specializing in apple cider mini donuts, traveling all over, setting up at different events. This year, I'm happy to announce that we are a proud partner of the Carolina Thunderbirds, and we're going to be set up inside the Annex building all season long at every home game. So while you're out supporting your favorite hockey team, swing by and warm up with some hot, fresh apple cider mini donuts made on site right when you order. Thank you. Hope you have a great day. And go Birds.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
Back here getting ready for the start of the third period here from the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV, getting set to bring you the final 20 minutes from upstate New York. This is the only trip to Binghamton for the Thunderbirds this season, as Jan Salak as well as Jesse Anderson both make their way over to the benches after unsportsmanlike conducts. So we will have 4-on-4 action. And it looks like right now to start off this third period. The third period this season, as always, is brought to you by Mustin and Crutchfield. And the Thunderbirds holding on to a 2-1 lead despite being outshot by 19, 35-16, and our contact shots on goal counter here this season. Pair on sportsmanlike contacts have two in the box. So some open ice to start this third period for both sides. Saw 3-on-3 last night in the 5-minute overtime. Saw 4-on-4 early on in this game as well. Gus Ford in for the faceoff against Tyson Kirkby. And for the draw, and we're underway here in the final 20 minutes from Binghamton, New York. It'll be the Black Bears that control first over on the far side. Binghamton will work it up to Gavin Yates, who walks over the blue line, walks up the far side, tries to dance around Felder, spins him off, brings it back out to the point. Here's Stone. Near side, Bond looking, throws one in on Cavalieri, makes the initial save, a rebound attempt, and Cavalieri is able to get back to his post and stick the leg out and make the save. A good first save here from Mario Cavalieri has been tremendous. Here's Gus Ford, his shot's deflected over the glass, puck gets batted around, and Yates comes away with it. Thunderbirds bring out a couple of fresh skaters with Kennedy and Firth now out there. At the far side, Yates drops it off. Firth will step up, bang this one, it goes over a stick, bounces around. Roman Kramer will bank. Bang it behind the net. Cavalieri gets a touch to it before Kennedy sends it back out, but only to Stanko. Stanko walks in, a shot saved by Cavalieri. Puck still loose, though, and Kramer, he'll control. Bring it behind his own net as we have a minute gone here in the third period. 1 minute remaining of 4-on-4 action as now a man loses an edge behind the net. Here come the Thunderbirds with Joe Kennedy up the far side. Across the blue line, walks in, now brings it to the near side. He'll send one wide that comes out on the far side to the half boards, and Brendan Stanko. Stretch pass, trying to get it to Connor. Smith takes a deflection, and now Smith, he is able to get this one back in deep as a man goes down to the ground. No call as Clay Keeley loses his stick, and now a call comes all the way from not the official in the corner, but from the official that was still in the Thunderbirds attacking end. And they're going to call a trip against Clay Keeley. So for the next 41 seconds, we'll have 4-on-3. So 4-on-3 action for the next 41 seconds after this 2-minute minor. Face-off is cleared all the way back down where Egbert comes out, and he'll play it over on the far side. Keeley calling for 2 minutes on the trip. 30 seconds left of this 4-on-3 before one man comes out of each box over on the far side in the sin bins. It's rattled off the boards by Bond and comes all the way out to the near side for Stanko. In the near half boards, 4-on-3 action for the next 20. Smith walks in, top of the net, a shot, and Cavalier is able to get a blocker there. It takes a high deflection off of the high glass, and it looks like this one ended up going out of play. Cavalieri got the blocker there. They're going to say ended up in the protective netting. So now it's a face-off to the left of him with 13 seconds remaining here on the 4-on-3. Ensuing face-off is won by Binghamton. Out at the point, Yates glides along with Schnapp on him. Comes back out, top of the slot, a shot, and that one sails high. Comes back right out in front. Puck loose in the crease. It's whacked away. Comes back out to the point as both men come out of the box. Now 5-on-4. Power play for the next minute, 17. Kirkby walks in. Near side shot and a save by Cavalieri before it comes back out. On the near side now, Thompson at the dot. Looks up, tries to send one across. Schnapp got a stick there. Salak tries to clear. He's not able to before Anderson throws it off of a man's skate and it comes back out as Yates has to go down and recollect. 5-on-4 for the next 56 seconds. Yates walks in at the near half boards. Back out to the point with Jesse Anderson, who just came out of the box after the unsportsmanlike conduct with Jan Salak. On the far side now, back out to the point. Yates, who already has a goal tonight, gets it back down low to Anderson. Anderson brings it back out, goes cross ice. Walking in, a shot, and that one takes a deflection high and wide. Anderson, cross ice again to Liam Anderson before Jesse Anderson gets it right back. It hits a man, and this one comes back out to center ice. Now the foot race is on. Here comes Butide. He brings it into the zone. Well, now wait. Get it to Kennedy with 23 to go here on the penalty kill for the Thunderbirds. 4-on-4, then 4-on-3, and then 5-on-4. Thunderbirds trying to get back to 5-on-5 action here. Tied up in the corner with 10 to go here on the penalty kill for the Thunderbirds. 16:45 left to go in the third period, and a 2-1 advantage for the visitors. Stanko up the far side. Gets to the half board. He drops it off for Ivashkin. Walks into the high slot. Doesn't get all of it on his shot. It comes out on the near side. Clay Keeley out of the box. Back to 5-on-5 action. Ivashkin runs in to Gus Ford as well as the official behind the net. Where it squirts free. Stanko throws one in, and it takes a deflection wide. Ivashkin, though, walks right back out in front. His shot goes off of a skate and goes up into the netting, and it brings up a stoppage with 16:20 remaining here in this third period. So the Thunderbirds a lot of time in their defensive zone here in this third period, but they've been able to kill off a 4-on-3 and then a 5-on-4 after the period started. And 4-on-4. Gus Ford and Brendan Stanko in for the draw to the left of Cavalieri. 16:20 remaining. Faceoff is won by Stanko. Back out to the point. It's rattled all the way back around where Gregory Felder goes into the corner to pick it up. Plays on the backhand. Dawson Baker ends up losing it and comes all the way out to the far half boards. Kramer just tries to whack it back out to center ice, but it comes back to Ford. Tries to get past Stanko. Ends up knocking it out of the air before Ford gets tied up again, and it comes back out to the far point. Bailar throws it off the boards. Gus Ford intercepts, and here come the Thunderbirds back into the neutral zone. Ford will dump it in deep. Egbert will play it from his crease. Comes out on the near side. Roman Kramer, the first one there for the Thunderbirds. He just shuffles it back along. Weaver plays. He runs into Baker, and now the puck squirts back out just on the far side of the net. And now Binghamton will reset. Stanko's pass goes wanting to Ivashkin before it's sent back in by Felder. And now here comes a chance for Binghamton up the far side. Stanko walks in, and a blocker saved by Cavalieri. Weaver and Kramer battling. Kramer, or rather Dumas, will get enough on it as this one comes all the way back in. Egbert leaves it for Stone. Stone now up on the far side. Throws it back out to center ice where Gesso walks in. Surveys, he throws one in. Cavalieri another save as he saves this one. It goes off the back of the glass. And now on the near side, here comes Peter Panacek. Throws it back out, goes past Dumas, and comes all the way back to Connor Smith with 14:57 remaining here in this third period. A 2-1 advantage for the Thunderbirds. A kick there, and now Gesso gets his pocket picked. Salak going against Stone before Gesso gets it back, comes near side to Logar. Logar, a stretch pass out to the far side, and here comes Binghamton into the attacking zone. Walking in, a shot, and they score. A Austin Thompson. Gets his fifth goal on the season. And the stretch pass out to the far side. He just walked in, and he's able to beat Mario Cavalieri up top. And with 14:38 remaining here in the third period, we are tied at two. So we got a brand new game once again here in Binghamton. It's been an entertaining weekend so far as now Nate Keeley and Logan tying up on the ensuing faceoff as the faceoff is won by Kessler. Sky played all the way back in where Tucker Firth has to recollect. Plays it up to the near half boards. Nate Keeley trying to angle off a defender where the puck comes back out. Just so, with Keeley all over him. It's to Stone who rattles it around the boards. Thompson, the goal scorer, gets it back out. Bond walks in, a shot, and Cavalieri makes the save. Logar and Gesso get the assist. Here's Gesso. Spinning around Firth. The 2:22s go at it before it's brought out on the far side. All Binghamton right now as we approach 14 minutes to go in the third. Gesso at the top of the slot. Throws one. This one goes high off of the glass. And they're going to say it got him into the protective netting. So 13:58 remains here in regulation in Binghamton. We are tied up at two. So we'll take a timeout. We're back after this here on Thunderbirds TV.
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
So Austin Thompson at the 5:22 mark of this third period has us tied at two with 13:58 remaining here in the third period. Thunderbirds last night, a 5-4 win. They still have not trailed this weekend here against Binghamton. But tonight, two men down. Yuri Peshtuka didn't make the trip, as well as Curtis Hagee, who exited last night's game. Thunderbirds only five defensemen. Right now, knotted up at two. Gus Ford in for the draw against Kirkby. To the left of Cavalieri. Ford is able to win the faceoff. Keeley, he receives the puck after he tried to bat it back out. Now here comes Gus Ford up the far side into the attacking zone. Dances in into the slot. Gets the puck batted around. This one goes high up in the air. Goes up off the top of the glass. And they're going to say it was played with a high stick. So the Thunderbirds being outshot 42-17 on our Comtech shots on goal tracker. But an offensive zone face-off here. Thunderbirds trying to hand Binghamton two straight losses here this weekend and for the first time this season. Ford gets tied up. Baker steps in before Yates spins his way back out, throws this one back out. Lewis now going against Keeley, walks in, and a save by Cavalieri. Takes a weird hop off of the half boards before Baker throws a good hit there on Yates, and it comes all the way back out to center ice as Jesse Anderson, he recollects. Goes over to Liam Anderson on the far side. 13:20 remains here in the third period. Into the far corner, good hit there by Clay Keeley. He disposes of a man, but now a tie-up in the corner. Keeley just pinning the man up against the boards. Before it comes out on the near side, and Gregory Felder gets it up to Dominic Dumas, who walks across the red line, tries to get it up to Jan Salak, who's offside. He's able to get back onside, no, but now Dumas has to do the same before Salak is able to angle off a man and a sharp pass over to Peter Panacek from Tucker Firth, but it comes right back to Firth and then to Jordan Popoff. Panacek at the far side into the attacking zone. He's able to win this one all the way back behind the net, where Salak's able to step in with him. Thunderbirds pinching down. Panacek now on the near side now. Man goes down to the ice before it comes back behind Egbert in the net. And it's rattled back up to the half board. 12:28 remains in the third period. It's 2-2. Stenko across the blue line, gets it back. A shot, and that one's blocked by Firth. Salak picks it up, and he's able to get this one out to the blue line before Panacek comes away with it. He'll reset. He's calling for a change here with 12:10 left to go here in the third period. He will leave it for Tucker Firth as he makes his way off the ice, and the third line comes out for the Thunderbirds. 12 minutes remain. 43-17, the shots in favor of Binghamton. Well, the Thunderbirds tied at two. Mario Cavalieri, 41-43 saves as Firth will get this one and clear the zone to Nate Keeley. Backhands it in all the way into the near side. Took a deflection. No icing if it got all the way down. Weber will rattle this one out to the far side. Austin Thompson. He leaves it for Jussieu, who walks in, trying to go to work against Schnapp. Nice job by Schnapp, being able to run off a few Black Bears, and the puck comes back out to center ice before it's bounced back into the defensive zone. And Weber, he collects on his forehand, now spins his way back behind his own net. Nate Keeley closing on him, gives him a little shove after the pass got away. This one's lofted all the way back down. Clay Keeley back to get to it. They call off icing at the last second as Joe Kennedy is able to clear the zone. Bond goes cross ice to his D partner, Daniel Stone. Stone dumps it in, cross corner. Joe Kennedy now bangs it back out. Bond stepping up on the forecheck. He leaves it for Yates here in the near half boards. Yates gets a stick lifted by Kramer. Puck still not cleared, and now Nate Keeley has it. Gets it up to Kramer, walks in. Kramer spins away from a defender, now waiting for reinforcements as he'll dump this one in. Egbert out from his crease to play it with Dawson Baker closing in, goes opposite side, and it's lofted back out to center ice by Daniel Stone as we are near the halfway mark of the third period. 2-2 your score. Baker gets a stick to this one. This is going to go all the way down. Where Stone, he takes a hit from Baker, finishing off his check. This one's deflected high in the air, and they're going to say that it went out of play. Say it took a deflection, so no delay of game against Binghamton. It's going up into the protective netting, but it will bring up an attacking zone faceoff for Gus Ford to the right of Nolan Egbert. Thunderbirds trying to get out of Binghamton with a couple of wins here this weekend. They're not having a conversation. They do say that it was deflected, so as previously mentioned, no delay of game call. Ford in for the faceoff against Kirkby. Faceoff is won by Kirkby, and it's played out on the far side. Ford comes back out to center ice. Felder steps up. He'll dump this one in with Ford chasing after, and Jesse Anderson into the corner. And they call offside on the Thunderbirds. Another good crowd here in Binghamton here on Veterans Day. Here at the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena here in upstate New York. Thunderbirds trying to improve. It's a 5-1-0 this season and hand Binghamton a regulation loss, something that has not happened across the Black Bears' first 8 games. Ford and Kirkby in for the draw in the neutral zone. Kirkby wins it and zip quickly over to Liam Anderson, who will dump this one in on the backhand with Cavalieri back to get it. Quickly, he has to wrap it back around. Jesse Anderson will throw one in. Firth is able to catch it with his glove before he plays a stretch pass out to Gus Ford. Here's Ford into the corner with Jesse Anderson. Anderson wins the foot race and leaves it for Liam Anderson. Ford's played back out to center ice and now into the attacking zone. Anderson walks in a shot, and that one's blocked by Firth. Puck still loose in the corner, though, before it comes out, and Firth disposes of a man behind the net. Joe Kennedy plays it quickly up the half boards to Dominic Dumas, who leaves it for Gus Ford, who walks in into the attacking zone, tries to dance through. Dumas comes away with it as now the puck trickles in the corner. Ford trying to find it as Slot joins in there. Slot is able to pick it up, bring it around on the far side, and now spins back behind the net. Slot on his backhand in the corner, going to work against Liam Anderson. Slot brings it back out on the far side, disposes of Anderson, now gets it back out to the point where Kennedy will wrap it around, but Peter Panacek ending up joining the rush on the near half boards. Leaves it for Dumas. Good offensive zone time here for the Thunderbirds, who have started to grow into this third period. Puck comes free into the near corner before it's lofted all the way back up to center ice and all the way down. Cavalieri calling for icing, and he will get it. 9:06 remains here in period number three. It'll be an offensive zone faceoff for the Thunderbirds when we return. Here tied at two from the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Back with more after this on Thunderbirds TV.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where technology.
Thank you. 9:06 remains on the third period here in Binghamton. Thunderbirds and Black Bears knotted up at 2. It was Austin Thompson at the 5:22 mark of this third period. And he's made it a 2-2 game. And now the Thunderbirds, fresh off an icing, have an attacking zone faceoff to the left of Nolan Egbert. Faceoff is won by Stenko into the corner for Binghamton. A couple of white sweaters back there as Panacek is able to come away with it, but only for a second, though, before it's played out onto the far side and out to center ice. A quick toss pass by Jesse Anderson. Here's Ivashkin spinning around on the far side before he meets Joe Kennedy in the corner. Jordan Popoff gets his stick lifted by Stenko. It comes back out to the near half boards. Puck rattles all the way back around with 8.5 to go here in the third period. Joe Kennedy is able to clear the zone only as far as the Thunderbirds bench here on the near side for Panacek. We'll just backhand this one in. Connor Smith's able to knock it down. He goes quickly cross ice to Stenko. Here comes Stenko. Thunderbirds get it. Tucker Firth right back out in the ice with Kessler, Sky, Cavalieri. Backhands this one into the far corner where Ivashkin ends up meeting a white sweater and Jan Salak before the puck comes free. Back out to Panacek. We'll bring it out from behind his own net. Leaves it on the far side for Gregory Felder. Under 8 to go here in the third period. 2-2. We're tied up. Another good one here from the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. On the far side, just so. He brings it across the Black Bears logo at center ice and leaves it for Logar. Steps in into the slot. A nice poke check there by Felder. Kessler Sky trying to clear the zone. He's already got a goal tonight, and he's able to. Nate Keeley now up to Sky, up the far side in the far half boards. He takes a high stick, and now the Thunderbirds going to have a power play coming up as the puck bounces around. And here with 7:31 remaining here in the third period, the Thunderbirds are going to be going on the man advantage. So a great job there by Kessler Sky being able to draw the penalty. So man heads off to the box, and now the Thunderbirds chance to regain the lead here. Boylar goes to the penalty box for the second time here tonight for the high stick. Faceoff is won by Kirkby. Stone behind the net, runs into two Thunderbirds before Bond has it on his stick, plays it quickly up into center ice, and now here comes Kirkby across the blue line, walks in, and a save by Cavalieri, and he has to freeze with 7:18 remaining in this third period. So with a 2-2 score and the Thunderbirds on the power play for the next minute, 48, a defensive zone faceoff. Dawson Baker in for the draw against Andrew Logar. Baker's able to win it and get it back to Gus Ford, who quickly plays it over to Tucker Firth, who's already got a goal tonight, scored 69 seconds into this one. He rattles one around the boards, out into the near half boards, where Dominic Dumas plays it back behind the net for Stone, who bangs it off the glass and goes all the way 200 feet down as we're under 7 minutes to go here in the third period. Cavalieri leaves it for Tucker Firth. Firth now, a quick stretch pass out to Roman Kramer, who walks into the neutral zone, into the attacking zone, near half boards, trying to leave it for Ford. It ends up being left there as Logar is able to win it, and he clears it back out into the Thunderbird zone. Just over a minute remaining on the 2-minute minor. On the near side, Salak plays it with a hand, as now the Thunderbirds are offside. Lewis over on the far side to Kirkby, as now it's back to Liam Anderson. And he'll just dump this one down. Firth will chase after it. He has Lewis coming after him as he backhands this one all the way out to a vacant point. Jan Salak will be the first one to get there as he's able to win the battle against Liam Anderson with 40 remaining on the power play. Schnapp walks in. He goes down. No call from the official over at the far blue line. Spetsita now battling in the corner, but Anderson gets to it first. It comes out. Keeley is able to keep it in. Salak now goes cross ice over to Panacek. Walks in, back out to Keeley, a one-timer, and a save by Egbert. Comes out into the near corner, back out to Keeley at the point. Plays off the boards to Salak. Already assist here tonight. Back to Keeley. Goes far side. Panacek. Back to Salak. Top of the dot. Panacek walks in, a shot, and that one goes just wide. Somehow Egbert saw it. Play down the near side. Another shot and a one-timer. That one's saved by Egbert before it's cleared. Man coming right out of the box is Boylarn as he touches it, but Clay Keeley's back as the penalty and the power play is over for the Thunderbirds. And power play brought to you by Little Italy as we approach the five-minute mark here in the third period. Only it's 2-on-1 right now in the zone as a man comes away with it, thrown in front. Ivoshkin stoned by Cavalieri. Puck still loose, so Thunderbirds were caught in a change trying to get their regular lines back out there. And Roman Kramer now controls up on the far side as we're under 5 minutes to go here in Binghamton in regulation. The Thunderbirds and Black Bears are tied at 2. Joe Kennedy in the neutral zone. Goes cross ice to Gregory Felder. His pass gets through, and Kramer will send this one back in. Thunderbirds only 5 defensemen here tonight, and here's Gus Ford. His shot is blocked by Bond. It comes up and bangs up against the back of the cage before it's brought back out to the half boards. Ivoshkin plays it back for Daniel Stone, who tries to get a stretch pass all the way in. This one goes all the way down, and this one will go for icing with 4:32 remaining here in period number 3. The final stretch of regulation is coming up on the other side of this timeout. Don't go anywhere. This is Thunderbirds Hockey on Thunderbirds TV.
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker. One with big heart, they were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start. From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score. So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
So the Thunderbirds, much like that second period, only 3 shots here in the third. They now shot 45-19. They're against the Binghamton Black Bears. But we're tied at 2 with 4:32 remaining here in the third period. And Steve Harrison will start with this third line. And Nate Keeley, Jacob Schnapp, and John Batito with Joe Kennedy and Gregory Felder. Face off to the left in the attacking zone of Nolan Egbert. A tie up on the draw. Stenko's able to win it, and this one's sent all the way off the boards. This one will come down on Cavalieri. He'll have to play it, and he'll have to cover, shaking his head. So a 4:23 remaining. A defensive zone faceoff coming right out of that media timeout. There's cleared all the way down, and Cavalieri, he didn't have much of a choice there. 2-2. Faceoff is won by Stenko back to Weaver. It's set across, and they score. A shot from the point. Took a deflection in front. And Brendan Stenko is there in the slot as he's able to tab it home, put it off the post and trickling in, beating Mario Cavalieri. And with 4:18 remaining in the third period, Binghamton has their first lead this weekend. So the Black Bears lead. Ensuing faceoff, Thunderbirds are able to win. Here's Clay Keeley, plays it off the glass. Out the far side, Boylarn tries to get it past the lock, and he does. This one comes all the way back down as we're about to enter the final 4 minutes here from Binghamton. Thunderbirds need one. Salak at the blue line, leaves it for Panacek. Here's Dumas, his shot gets deflected. Panacek comes away with it. Out on the far side, comes to Clay Keeley, a shot goes wide. Rebound, it's in for Dumas, it's loose in front. Egbert makes a save. Salak now in the corner to Dumas. Back out to the point, Tucker Firth. Dances around a defender, walks in, throws one across the crease, no one home. Clay Keeley stepping up on the forecheck. He gets ringed down to the glass. No call as this one comes down the far side. Ivoshkin's onside, and Firth is able to check him. Cavalieri makes a save and leaves it for Dumas. Oh, a huge save there from Mario Cavalieri, keeping the Thunderbirds in this one. Now here's Jan Salak with 3:17 remaining in the third period. Goes to Tucker Firth. Out to center ice. Baker gets a stick to it. And Liam Anderson back to collect as we approach 3 minutes to go here in the third period. Logar. Up the far side to Jusseau. Under 3 to go. He throws one in. Kennedy gets a glove to it. retreats back to his crease and behind his own net and spins around up on the far side looking for a stretch pass. Jusso intercepts at the blue line, brings it back out, throws one in on Cavalieri, who makes the save. He didn't know where it was, and so he'll have to cover. So a defensive zone faceoff with the Thunderbirds trailing 3-2 after Brendan Stenko for Matthew Boylar and Dan Weaver at the 15:42 mark. Forward in for the faceoff. It's one back on the far side. Stone a shot. Cavalieri reaches the blocker up and makes the save. As now Baker takes a whack at it. Second attempt. He gets it back out. They want off the stick of Kirkby and come all the way back in on Egbert. He'll throw out the far side. Kramer, he's able to get to it, and it's rattled all the way back in on the far side. Ford can't control. Now Kirkby goes to Bond on the near side as we're under 2.5 to go. Yates into the attacking zone, gets poke check, gets it back, spins back out. Kramer on him at the far half boards. Kramer in a battle back there. It's played off the boards. Gus Ford's going to be the first one to it. As we approach 2 minutes to go, we have to see when Mario Cavalieri is going to end up coming to the bench, and the Thunderbirds bring on the extra attacker. Ford dancing through into the attacking zone, into the slot now. Goes into the corner, plays it. It goes past the stick of a Binghamton defender as Roman Kramer dances by Bond. Throws one out in front, trying to get it to Schnapp. Didn't get all the way through. Stone got his stick there. Kramer now on the far side. Cavalieri calling for it over on the other end. Kramer walks it, throws one in front. Ford deflects it wide. There goes Cavalieri to the bench, 6-on-5. This one's cleared all the way back out. This one's going to go down, and this one's going to be icing, and it's going to bring up an attacking zone faceoff. So 6-on-5 now, with the net empty for the Thunderbirds, and Mario Cavalieri at the bench, saving 46 of 49 here this evening. Thunderbirds with only 19 shots. Now a face-off to the left of Nolan Egbert. And Binghamton will use their timeout. Steve Harrison already used the timeout. That was in the second period. Came after Binghamton tied it up, and then they had all the momentum. He called a timeout, was able to slow things down. Thunderbirds regained the lead on the Kessler Sky goal. But since then, two unanswered for Binghamton. Austin Thompson tied us at the 5:22 mark of this third period, and at the 15:42 mark, Brendan Stenko. Giving the Black Bears their first lead of the weekend. Thunderbirds never trailed yesterday and didn't trail until just a few minutes ago. Six on five. The Thunderbirds have one last charge in them. We're in a Saturday night in upstate New York. Gus Ford is in for the draw. It's Tyson Kirkby. Tie up on the draw. Comes back out to Salak, and the Thunderbirds control. Try to set things up. Salak's pass comes right back to him. He throws one in the crease. Comes out loose. Baker a shot, and it doesn't get all the way through. Salak plays it down for Panacek. Panacek, his pass gets deflected back out to center ice with 1:25 remaining, and the net still empty. Into the attacking zone. A tie up at the half boards. It's played into the corner. Salak from behind the net circles around, plays it back to Baker, goes cross ice, a one-timer, and that one sails high and goes off the back of the cage. Ford's able to get there, though. Back out to the point. Baker looking. He'll throw one on net, and a save. It comes back out loose in the slot, and it's played off of the boards and cleared as we're under 60 seconds to go here in the third period in Binghamton. Thunderbirds one last charge with the net empty. 6-on-5 action. Back in trying to clear it. It's ricochets all the way over the near side and played out to the near point. Baker steps in, throws one across the ice. Firth's going to have to get there. It's a foot race. Puck takes a deflection. Here comes Ivashkin. Empty nail. Oh, it is saved by Baker. Ivashkin gets it back, though, and he scores. With 40 seconds remaining, Nikita Ivashkin sends Binghamton up 2. So now the Thunderbirds are going to need to pull something out of a hat. What an effort by Dawson Baker there, laying out. Made the initial save, but just a lucky hop brought it back out in front. So we have 35 seconds remaining here in the third period. Kennedy back behind the net. Leaves it for Nate Keeley. The two twins get it over to John Batito. Plays it off the boards with 25 left to go. Weber. Back in his own zone. It gets deflected by Stenko. This one played by Cavalieri with 15 to go. Binghamton with two late goals and three third period goals. Ended up taking game two here tonight. John Batita walks in, dancing in on Egbert, spins around, just tries throwing back out front with 2 seconds and one, and that will do it. So after 65 minutes last night and a shootout win, Binghamton comes out here tonight and takes down the Carolina Thunderbirds by a score of 4-2. Carolina, a defenseman down. Still in it until the very end before Nikita Ivashkin's empty netter closes things out for the Thunderbirds here on Saturday night in Binghamton. We'll wrap this one up quickly on the other side of this timeout on Thunderbirds TV.
What's up, everybody? My name is Zach Taylor, and I'm the owner.
Once upon a time, not so far away.
A truck company specializing in apple cider mini donuts, traveling all over, setting up at different events. This year, I'm happy to announce that we are a proud partner of the Carolina Thunderbirds, and we're going to be set up inside the Annex building all season long at every home game. So while you're out supporting your favorite hockey team, swing by and warm up with some hot, fresh apple cider mini donuts made on site right when you order. Thank you. Hope you have a great day, and go Birds.
Flow Cadillac is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive, or go online to flowcadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
Back here in Binghamton, getting ready to wrap this one up. 4-2 the final in favor of the Binghamton Black Bears here this evening, who take 3 points here tonight. The Thunderbirds, they drop to 4-2-0 on the season, while Binghamton improves to 6-0-3. Thunderbirds led for a good portion of this game, but three third period goals are the difference for the Binghamton Black Bears. Austin Thompson tied it with 5:22 remaining in the, or at the 5:22 mark. Brendan Stenko at the 15:42 mark, but Binghamton in front for the first time this weekend. The Nikita Ivashkin empty netter with 40 seconds remaining after Dawson Baker made a heck of a play, spreading it, laying out. But a lucky bounce brought it right back to Ivashkin, who was able to send the Thunderbirds home. But the Thunderbirds come away with 2 points here on the weekend as they now sit at 11 points heading into another home-and-home against the Blue Ridge Bobcats coming up next weekend. Game one coming up on Friday at home at the Annex. Game two on Saturday in Withville. Well, that do it for us here on a Saturday night in upstate New York. Don't forget, coming up on Wednesday this week, special Wednesday edition of the Coach Harry Show coming live from Earl starting at 7 p.m. That'll do it for us here this weekend. Signing off for the final time here from Binghamton, New York, Brendan Riley. We'll talk to you on Wednesday for the Coach Harry Show, and then talk to you coming up next Friday from home at the Annex for game one of that home-and-home set between Withville and Carolina.